Hello, everyone. Welcome to As Told by Asia. And this is one of my pickup piles. Again, welcome, everyone. And to all of my returning visitors, welcome back. I just appreciate every single one of you for taking the time to come onto my page and listen to what I have to say. Okay? The title of this reading is Honey Trap or Honeymoon. Are they using their good looks and charm and your attraction to them as a means to get something that they want or have a hidden agenda? Or is this the real thing and you're going to have honeymoon energies? It's going to be like a honeymoon vibe. And even if it's bad now, you'll get back to the good with the honeymoon. But if it's honey trap, no good. I'm going to, if you see, or as you can see here, we have not only figurines, but also stones, gems, rocks, whatever you want to call them, crystals in some senses. We have those in figurines, and you can choose off of either one, the figurine or the stone or gem, or you can simply pick because the both of them, you know, call you together. And if you're not looking to use any of these, I'm going to take everything off and let you pick with just the cards. It's only going to be probably 15 seconds, if that, of me recording just the cards, and I'm going to ask you to pause it when we get to that part, because I won't be staying on that for long. You can just pause it. Everything is going to be time stamped. This, of course, the meditation part for this is going to be time stamped, and the part for no gems and no figurines is also going to be time stamped. And please, if you do not like the music that I'm going to play behind the meditation, just pause the video, okay? Because some people may enjoy it, some people may not. I would like to give an honor to God for all things, wake me up and letting me have a nice warm place to sleep, this gift that he's given me, the wisdom, the knowledge, the love in my heart to want to share it, the roof over my head, the clothes on my back, the food on my table, my kids, the breath within my body, my life, health, and strength, all of it, my family, all of it. I'd like to thank him for it all. This is for entertainment purposes only. This is not for you to take as instructions or plan for you to partake in. I would suggest it be used as guidelines, friendly advice, a different perspective on a situation, but never ever instructions or directions. Always use your own judgment. What you see, what you feel, what you hear, it can be clarified here and confirmed and solidified here, with my reading and others is what I mean here, as in YouTube and such. But never make readings and things like this the basis of your decisions. Your energy can change at any time. I'm an energy reader. I do not read the future. I cannot read the future. I don't believe that that's possible. I just believe that you can read energies. So if you change your energy, you change the situation. I do not own any rights to any music you may hear. I do not own any of the decks, the images, or the meanings. All of those things, other than probably the music, because I might not be able to keep up with the music that I'm hearing or who it is, because there's certain playlists that are just live music playing. It's not really a person who's putting it up. I will put all the deck names and the creator of the deck in the description. I just had like a total brain fart. So your options are the Piglet, the first deck, number 1, 2, 3, 4. The first pile with Piglet and the sliced geoid. We have pile 2 with Eeyore and the Amazonite. We have Winnie the Pooh on the third pile with the half citrine, half crystal quartz tumblestone. And last but certainly not least, we have Tigger at the end with the fourth pile and the tiger's eye. You see how I did that? You see? Okay. So I'm about to go into the meditation part where you can take a second to check out what you'd want. Check out the timestamps below in the description. Piglet with the sliced geoid, Eeyore with the Amazonite, Winnie the Pooh with the citrine clear quartz, and Tigger with the tiger's eye. 1, 2, 3, and 4. All right, so here we go. Okay, my beautiful and lovely people, for those who did not want gems nor figures, here we are. So I'm going to wait a couple seconds after I let my OCD get the best of me. I'm going to wait about 15 seconds and then I'm going to go on to the first reading. All right. So there you go. Hello, my pile one choosers. You are here because you chose Piglet, the sliced geoid, or just the first, you know, pile in general. We are going to do a few things. I'm going to use dice to begin. I have a saying back here that I chose by rolling dice of Piglets, and we're gonna see how it fits in at the end of the reading, if it fits in or not. Okay, let's get this reading started. Okay guys, quick little info on the sliced geoid that was accompanied by Piglet. The sliced geoid can have amethyst, citrine, clear quartz, or anything within it, because it really starts out as like a ball. It's when volcano is erupting and bubbles form on the outside and it starts to cool down, but on the inside is crystallization. On the outside, it's usually limestone or something along those lines. These things can get as big as like 2 to 6 feet tall, large, wide. What it does really depends on the core material. That's what I'm trying to say. The properties of the specific geoid really depends on what was in the center, and I want to say this was a clear quartz on the inside, some agate. If you can see the clear crystals, that's the clear quartz, I would say. And the white is, that's agate, because if you look, it looks like it would probably be tan or brown. And the white, that's agate. All right, so this is the sliced geoid. I have other geoids. This is part of a geoid that fell apart. And I had one that I cracked open myself. Here's a piece of this, that little blue thing. Here's the piece of the geoid. You see, like, it's rock on the outside and then crystally on the inside. You can always look up what a geoid is also if I didn't describe it well enough. The geoid can be used for higher power purposes, higher perspective, and looking at the bigger picture. You can get closer to, or attempt, or not attempt, but like use it to try to reach your higher self or the higher council of you. It can draw in negative energy and then it transmutes it into positive energy. And it's sometimes placed in healing grids. Okay. Healing grids and the, on the actual body for healing. Sorry, little brain fart there. Okay. We are going to first begin with using the die. There's several different shapes and sided die here for specific parts of the reading. Okay. So let's get an overall energy of this person's right now. Okay, what's going on with them? Let's get a little bit of insight, a little like a summary. Two. So first and foremost, the two is fire, which is spirituality, passion, anger, ideals. Someone who has an ideal of the way something should be, regardless of it, if it is that way or if you want it that way. Fire is action, anger, passion. This person is feeling very intense feelings right now. Their energy is very hot, very fiery, very passionate, very ready to move, make a move, make action. I feel like it's very emotional overall. Like it stems from an emotional thing. Okay. Next is this one, and I see the three first, so I'm going to place it here. Over here, I'm gonna put the three so you can see it there you go. All right, so the two and the three in die is the four-sided die is element. What element is involved? And we have fire. And the six-sided die is what is the problem? And the problem here is thought. There are paradigms getting in the way. Not in touch with reality. Someone's very judgmental. This individual that is showing up here in your reading is really starting to think a little differently. I feel like they just went through a very, very traumatic or life-changing, large, notable, memorable situation in an emotional sense. Like they are emotionally either just getting over a situation, just healing, or still not even like close to it, still going through the drama and the emotions and such. The next die is the 10 die, and there's two of them, and it ranges difficulty. Here's the other one. 26. So the difficulty level for this person is 26. So if you guys are broken up, they're not as devastated as they may be acting. If you guys are together, I feel like this person is fighting mind and body, possibly heart and mind, heart and body. They're having a conflict within itself. I don't even see it being an external conflict. I see it being a conflict within itself. And now that I see right here, I didn't even do this on purpose, but I lined it up in front of the door. I feel like this is like the beginning, like a doorway for this person. They're becoming anew, or they're like having a different way of thinking. Their fear and anxiety, possibly their judgmental attitude here, very fear-based. Okay, very fear-based. Keep that in mind if you're being attacked at any point, verbally. They're very much stuck in their head, but yet very much trying to be in the physical world too, doing actions, making moves, possibly because you are. Possibly following after you, possibly trying to improve, impress you. The difficulty level, like I said, is the 26. They really just need to come to a balance with heart and mind, body and spirit. Think from different perspectives than they're thinking now, because I feel like they have a very one-track-minded kind of way of thinking. Too busy thinking far into the future to even consider what's going on now. And that's the important part, because that's the part that keeps setting this person back more and more, is the present. And they just keep on trying to plan the future. Okay, so we have also the 6, because it has the dot on the bottom. So this, the number, I don't know if I said card. I think I might have called this a card. I've been doing it since I started using these die. The die numbers, this is a 12-sided die, and it's the number 6. Okay, number 6 on the 12-sided die can either mean 6 p.m., summertime, June, waiting for a harvest, finding shade, time to relax. I'm seeing that. I'm seeing rest and dream, restore yourself. And the lesson here is the 13, which is the death card, to cut something off completely, to end something, to be able to start something new. Okay, old ways, the old makes way for new, the life cycles, we all will perish in the end, reinvention of self. So I really feel like this individual is having a whole transformation of life. I don't know if something happened in June or something is going to happen in June. Something happened around 6 p.m. one day, or something happened in the summer when it was time to relax and you were waiting for the like fruits of your labor to be produced or given to you. Something happened and it caused this huge revelation within this person. They have a lot of passion, and I feel like that's what's really pushing them through this transformation for sure. So now that we see this person is having a heart and mind, or a physical and spiritual battle within themselves, that should ease up your feelings a little bit about, you know, feeling like you're not enough or unwanted, anything like that. Unattractive, anything like that. It's definitely not you. Okay. So I have some tarot cards that I'm going to start with. I actually have this whole pile like you picked or whatever, but I'm going to be, if I feel the need to, pick from another deck that I have sitting over here on the sidelines on standby. Okay, so the first card that you have is the 7 of Pentacles. This is an energy. I feel like this person really is or has been nurturing is the word I'm trying to say, their works, their resources, taking care of it, loving it, you know, not taking it for granted. So far, so good. We have the Prince of Cups. Okay, yeah. They're trying to come in with this big energy of emotion, trying to show you that they're beneficial to your emotional needs. The Two of Swords. But I'm feeling like they want you to make a decision, or they need to make a decision. And if they don't, they can't be with you, or they want you to make a decision. And they're saying, if you don't, we can't be together. Literally tearing one or the other of you apart. The Hermit or the Alien card, okay? Pulling back of this person, they care about you so much, they love you so much, they want to be with you, they want to be around you, they want to tell you, they want to call you and talk to you. They're probably not the calling and talking all the time type of person, but they do miss or want or need that from you. And lately they've been really pulling back, and although they've been I feel like they're sending mixed signals. This person has like a mixed energy, mixed signals. We can only just keep looking. All right, let's see what Oracle. Oh, we have the 21 in reverse. The This is the reverse of life, the cosmic womb, the cosmic egg. In reverse. The cosmic egg in reverse is an energy of emotional blockage, delay, excessive daydreaming, flights from reality. Wow, disconnected from reality was this card, I believe, or that one. One of these card, one of those die. Okay, flight from reality, undirected thoughts, passivity, blockage of the life forces, and poisoning. So all around in this situation, I'm feeling like mental anguish. I feel like this person is really going through some mental anguish. You know what? It could be you going through mental anguish. This person could be really, really putting you through mental anguish, but I don't think that they are. I feel like they're the one going through this feeling. Either because you broke their heart, maybe they deserved it. Nobody really deserved it, but like maybe it was a result of their own actions. Okay. I feel like this is just something they did on their own. Oh my gosh, look, 1111, twin flame energy. Could it be? Because that is twin flame energy, 1111. Let's just continue to pull the cards. So now I'm going to pull, we have these four Akashic Record cards. These Akashic Records cards are part of the new cards that I got a couple new decks, and I really do like them. Let's see how they work out in your reading. We have the One. Wow, the Oracle of Delphi in reverse, no less. Let's put this up here. The Oracle of Delphi. Okay, sorry Piglet, you're gonna get covered up. Sorry. The next card is, wow, you have the One and the Two, the Akashic Library. Okay, I'm going to explain them after I pull them all. Our third card is the Seven of Forces. We were just talking about forces, weren't we? And the last card, the Seven of Forces, balance, and that's in reverse. And lastly, the Seven of Roses in the upright. So you have the One in reverse, the Two in upright, the Seven of Forces in reverse, and the Seven of Roses in the upright. The journey. Alrighty. I do like these cards. I wonder where they're gonna take us. With the One in reverse, the Oracle of Delphi, this is saying that you've been denying your intuition, not listening to it, not listening to your higher self, a spirit, God, whatever. You're not listening, and you've been urged to listen. It's like a little voice. It's been nudging you in a certain direction, and you've just been straight up denying it, or you are having a really hard time hearing this message that is just being thrown at you. With the Two in the upright, the Akashic Library, the sage sits in the library that is being illuminated by candles, and it's, you're getting more access to your Akashic records, your memories, your old motives and new purposes is what is stated in this deck. And basically what this also says is there's a book that is going to give you some kind of clarity or answers today. So if there's a book that catches your attention or just kind of like calls you to it, let it fall open to a page and pick a passage, read it, and reflect on those words for the rest of the day. Don't assume that this passage is going to address the most urgent or the most prominent thing in your life. It may address something else, something further back on like the stove, you know, the back burner, or even something that you may think is very mediocre or minuscule, unimportant, but In all reality, it has everything to do with all the big things you're worried about. Okay, so this card down here, in reverse, I don't know if you remember or you caught that it is a blockage of forces. And I want to show you, this is a force in reverse, a blockage of forces. So I'm going to clarify that with some other cards. But first, let's go through these. The balance in reverse, the blockage of these forces, which is kind of, I don't want to say insane because, you know, things happen to me all the time and nothing's really crazy anymore. But I wasn't expecting it. So the seven of forces in reverse. In reverse, this card indicates that you may be out of balance and embroiled in some difficult situation that has caused you to lose clarity or even lose your power. This could include stressful legal matters or a situation that may seem unjust to you, unfair. You may feel all tied up in red tape, but you need to be proactive here. Take the action needed. The action needed. The action they needed was the right concept. I don't remember. It's not that important. I can always check again. anyway. The right concentration. There you go. Okay, so anyway, take the action needed to untie the situation bit by bit. Acquire good counsel and advice to see this situation through and help you to get all the details straightened out. The outcome may not go exactly as desired, but remember to keep your balance. Seek only justice. Realize revenge. Release revenge and anger. And don't want your urgent attachments to create difficult karma for you later. On a personal level, this reveals a warning to you to get centered and balanced once again. Bring balance back to your diet, your physical exercise, your mind. Consider how your choices and thoughts are going to impact your future in this life and the lifetimes to come. Take the action that will set a scale back in balance, not just between you and others, but within your life as well. There may be components of your daily schedule that have thrown you off center. It's time that you get set and get these things set right again. When all things are balanced, a good energy you send out will attract the good energy, the great energy, the wonderful energy back to you. I feel like this Russian emotion, okay. This is what just dropped in my head. You are being given an ultimatum of some sorts, like an emotional one that is affecting your mental or your pentacles. It's like this emotional, this rush of emotion, this rush of emotional benefit. It's like, okay, you choose me or work, or you choose me or your family, or me or your friends. You know, I feel like they're like, okay, you're dominant or you're submissive, and that's it, because I'm dominant, so you have to be submissive, kind of energy. Okay, now we're just going to go over to the Seven of Roses, and I just want to also point out, water upside down would be pouring out, and the next one is roses. It's two sevens, nourishing one another. So with this situation where you're feeling unjust, unhappy with it, you're feeling like you're not getting your, you know, piece of the pie, your due part. In the upright, the Seven of Roses is a card that shows a time for a journey, a move, a relocation. You may be taking your work or your creative endeavors in a whole new direction, whether figuratively a new industry or literally a new city. However, this journey occurs. And when it does, it sure seems to take you to new places and greater opportunities. Although it may require leaving something safe behind, this is not a time for staying safe in the harbor. It is time for finding and exploring new worlds. So get packed. Okay. If you were thinking about moving to get away from a situation that makes you feel suppressed, like a situation that makes you feel like you can't be yourself, that you have to lie, that you have to hide anything that's deceitful or makes you feel guilty, you're not supposed to be doing it, and that's not a good situation for you to be in then. Okay. I try to like make people understand that when they're like, oh, well, am I wrong? Or is this the right thing to do? Or is it me or is it them? If it doesn't line up with your soul, then it's wrong. In order to get a deeper look, I'm going to use these cards to clarify this here. And I'm going to pull different cards to clarify those. So we have the King of Pentacles. We have the Ace of Pentacles, and we have the Ten of Wands. I'm sorry. I know that my angle changes often, but I want to make sure that you get a full view of everything. And plus, my storage started acting up, so I paused. The King of Pentacles, the Ace of Pentacles, and the Ten of Wands have clarified the 21st rune, the cosmic egg, I believe, river of life, earthy womb, feminine womb, something along those lines. And I'm talking about this card. Where's my wand? I can't find my one that lights up, and it kind of makes me sad. All right. With the King of Pentacles and the Ace of Pentacles here, I feel like there's a big earth energy. I feel like there could possibly be a water energy because of this one and this one, and that. But this is earth. This could be viewed as earthly. So could this. So I'm feeling like very much earth energy, Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus, or it can be a water sign, which is Cancer, Pisces, or Scorpio. With this emotional blockage and being clarified with the King of Pentacles, I'm feeling as though you need a balance of masculine and feminine. Okay, you need that balance of masculine and feminine. You need to have an abundance of both. Realize that you have a maturity within yourself, within your mind, every time you're tempted to step out of your character. Okay? You are at a place in your life where you can't really turn to people like they can turn to you. You really can't turn to people because they can't fathom really your problems. Not that they can't fathom them, they're just like too big for certain people, or too humble for certain people, you know. So I'm feeling like an energy of suppression, needing to express yourself, and I say do so because you don't want to end up at the point where you feel like you're going to explode and you end up a walking ticking time bomb. I'm going to grab some tarot cards so that I can clarify these, but I do urge you, keep the maturity within your head. Your emotional imbalance, it can be controlled by mental stability, emotional understanding, emotional intelligence, and an understanding of the importance or the lack of importance of resources. Okay, so my verdict so far, this person is more honey trapped than honeymoon. Okay. They are more honey trapped than honeymoon, and that is no good, honey. Okay, I'm going to clarify these energies up here of you. Because their energy is one that's a very mental situation, and I see them come up here. I feel like you're being like asked, made, or forced to make a decision. Urged, rushed, nudged, pushed, cornered, I don't know. The Daughter of Swords. Okay. With the Daughter of Swords, I'm feeling as though you are getting a lot of new ideas, which might be influencing your intuition. I feel like that is confusing you because you're not cementing these knowledges and information into a foundation of fact of any kind, a proof, experiment, any kind of fact that can not be wavered, something to compare it to, you know? And I'm feeling like with this person who seems to be pushing and pulling, who seems to be chasing and running, like it's like a game of tag. I feel like you have a lot of like new thoughts always in your head. And I feel like that's why it's really hard for you to listen to yourself at the moment, because you don't know who yourself is. Yep, the priestess. Yep, the priestess card. Look, popped right out, right in front of the Akashic Records. A book is going to give you some kind of information or next step, an idea, perspective that you need. And it might not be the most important part of your life. It may not be the most prominent or the most urgent, but it will be a part of your life that if you partake or heed this situation, you may avoid a lot of unhappiness in the near future. Okay. So, like I was saying, you got the High Priestess card right in front of the Akashic Records. You have all this wisdom, knowledge, understanding that just comes with you from lifetime to lifetime, and you're accessing it at the moment. And I definitely feel like that's why you got the balance of forces, because if something just doesn't feel right, it just doesn't feel right. And seven is a very, I want to say divine number, angelic number. Angelic number is four. Divine number would be, I guess, seven. Yeah, because a holy number would be three, so the divine number would be seven. So yeah, I definitely feel like you're touched by God. You were sent here. Oh, I did anyway. You were sent here for a specific reason. Let's see what we have for the Seven of Forces. The Ace of Wands, total separate energy, the water and fire. For this imbalance, you need to step up and do something. I want to clarify, what is it that needs to be done? Okay. The Five of Pentacles in reverse. What needs to be done is you need to come to an understanding, a belief system, a foundation of one that is a correct one, one of moral standing and of, I don't want to say piety, but like very humble kind of energy, a very friendly, forgiving energy. That's the energy you should gear yourself towards. I see that your perspective on emotion, actions within emotions, possibly, it's all wrong. The things you've gotten out of those experiences have taught you these things, and they're incorrect. Seven of Roses, the Two of Pentacles in reverse, and I'm just going to ask for one more. Oh, wow, look, they're both butterflies. and they're both in reverse. The Six of Wands in reverse. So for the Seven of Roses, where there's a journey taking place, you are not very balanced. It's very obvious from the balance in reverse to this here, because the Two of Pentacles here, I have my wand. What am I doing? I found it. Because the Two of Pentacles here is generally an energy of transforming from not knowing what to do to having, like, focusing on the things that you know matter within the situation for a decision instead of the people around you, their thoughts, their ideas, and understanding. That's in reverse. The Six of Wands, which is the energy of being recognized and love of, like, either you loving what you do, people loving you for what you do, people loving what you do. This is all reversed. Because with the Balance card, having the Ace of Wands in the upright and the Five of Pentacles in reverse, I am just feeling like your actions are not yielding the results that you're wanting. So now you're, like, kind of losing interest. And as you're losing interest, you're losing fans, the person you want to notice you, the recognition that you want, the reputation you want, things like that. So far what this tells me is you're dealing with someone who is very physically present, okay? Whether they're always there or not, they're physically present. I want to say they may be a fire sign or an earth sign. I did think it was water, but the fire energy here, the fire energy here, the fire energy right here, that's kind of making me feel like they're a fire energy and you may be an earth energy or water energy. Okay. This individual is very like secretive. They play a lot of mind games, use a lot of word games. I feel as though they take back a lot of what they say, or they say, no, you know, I didn't say that, or no, remember I said this. And I feel like it's because they play a lot of mind games and word games with you that they can do that. They act like things are harder on them and for them than they really are. And it's an energy that either they need to cut this off completely or you need to cut them off completely. All right. I see, like, there is an energy here of a nurturer of resources and a big rush of an emotional benefit that's going to have somebody, like, cut in two and doing some isolation. And with the card that speaks of, it escapes me. Emotional blockages. Emotional blockages, excessive daydreaming, not being grounded or getting your work done, you're not getting your responsibilities taken care of. The fundamentals sometimes just go unnoticed because of this energy that you have of, like, distracted. And I feel like if this person here was really for you and about you, they would make sure you weren't feeling this way. I feel like they are literally, like, causing you to be distracted. They're coming in with this big rush of emotion while I feel like this was you. Okay. I feel like that's you working on your pentacles. The World, yes. You were working on something that you had not yet finished when this rush of emotion came in, and it looked very beneficial to you, okay? And I feel like this is you. I know, like, I was a little open to whose energy this was, but I really feel like this is you. Like, you're definitely all in this reading, even though we're trying to find out if this person is a honey trap or a honeymoon situation. This is all your energies and what it's doing to you. You had an emotional blockage, and this person kind of like made you feel like you felt again, but that wasn't real. I don't think. I think that was a fake thing here, and I think that's why you were split and ended up going into isolation. Are you near a balance? Let's check this one out first. The alien card. Actually, I want two cards for the Two of Swords. These two you saw that, right? You saw that. this split decision that you have to do. You have two choices, or you have a decision to make out of two things. Wow. The Magician. Wow. So you have the Magician and the High Priestess. So one choice is Magician, the other one is the Ace of Pentacles in reverse. Okay. I feel like this is like use it before you lose it kind of thing. You know, like this right here, this energy, this pentacle energy is that right there. And I'm feeling like you have a choice to use this energy that you're getting from this situation, this emotional blockage that is like either about to burst through or has, because of this false, I believe this was very false. Wow, almost went to the fire. Yeah, the Hermit. Wow, the Hermit in reverse, the Hermit in the upright. So yeah, it was a very false, yeah, and the Three of Cups, it was a very false energy. That person just came with false love. Oh geez, OMGs. And they seemed so wise, and it was just like, if it worked, it clicked, and everybody was happy, it seemed. Okay, confirming the Hermit, we have the Nine of Pentacles in reverse. So you were feeling discomfort. You were not feeling happy where you were. You were not feeling content or accomplished or anything in the situation. And I feel like that's why you left. They interrupted you from doing your thing, tricked you. You now or did have a choice to make out of, you know, honing your magician energy through this situation, or losing a pentacle, losing a resource, getting a blockage of a resource. And then on the alien, on top of that, you have the Nine of Pentacles in reverse. And that's not being content where you were, and now kind of like being in hermit mode for real, as opposed to this pretend hermit mode over here. Let me see anything else I would like to clarify over here. Okay, yeah. I just want to take my tail off of this thing, because I usually don't have it on, but I was hanging up. All right, here we go. Okay, I'm going to clarify. Let's just get it all. Four cards if possible. So the Temperance card in the reverse. This is a balance and this is an imbalance. So there's a blockage in your balance. What is this blockage? Oh, something tried to jump out. What is this blockage in your Temperance? Wow, and not letting go of something that's old and done for. Okay, and for the emotional blockage in the middle, okay, I want to get, okay, you have the Eight of Wands in the upright, oh, in the reverse, and the Eight of Cups in reverse, the Eight of Wands and the Eight of Cups in reverse, you have for this emotional blockage, this, ooh, my neck, it just got like really heavy for this emotional blockage, for this like indirect thought, this blockage of the life force that you're, that's energy, fire and water, life force indeed. I feel like with this, you are taking a lot of losses. That emotional blockage is either causing you to, or is in is a result of you not achieving anything that you set out to achieve with the Eight of Wands in reverse, and also of not being able to let go of something. Like, you have to, but you just really can't. And I believe it's the energy of this other person, okay? This person up here who was playing mental, like they've been playing mind games, and you probably don't have any swords because they have it all. They have all the swords. Wow. Okay. The Seven of Cups. Yes, the Seven of Cups in reverse. So, wow, you got the Eight of Cups and the Seven of Cups in reverse. So, with the Seven of Cups in reverse here, right underneath the Eight of Cups in reverse, there's just so much emotional, like, dumpage. And I don't know if it's you giving up on love or this person dumping all of their emotional baggage on you, but it's like someone's being, someone's, the person that they're putting on is not true. Okay, there's something about this energy that is just not true. Suppression card. Wow, I didn't even get to say anything. There's too many cards. I'm going to cut it a few times. So I want to clarify the suppression card. The Justice in reverse. This relationship has not been fair. This person is just not fair. And it makes sense why you can't get balanced. It just makes all the sense in the world why you can't balance out. Okay, the Lover's card. Oh, what is happening here? All right, guys. Whew, that was intense. Let's get... I want to do Oracle. I'm thinking, oh, okay, I forgot I pulled out these cards. These are already pulled out for you. These are, I want to say, Lightworker cards. Your work your light, and let's see what your light is. Play, have fun, celebrate, don't be so serious. I'm going to put this here. Your next card is, oh, they're all upside down. Trust your path. If you knew you would be supported, what would you do? Good question. And I have cards to pull for these. And this one says, Anna, grandmother of Jesus. Anna, right. This is true. And that is his grandmother. Seeding the light, laying foundations, and divine plan. I have cards that I want to pull specifically for these three. For these work your light cards, we're going to pull from this star seed. Okay, here's the first one. For this card, play, have fun, celebrate, don't be so serious. We have all paths lead home, inner authority, intuition, and turn your gaze within. Okay. For trust your own path, wow. All paths lead to home. I believe it. Trust your path. If you knew you would support it, you would be supported, what would you do? All paths lead to home. I don't believe that this goes to any of them, so I'm just gonna look and put my arm all in front of the thing. That's so unlike me. Sorry, guys. Okay, now the next card that comes out is for the play card. It's going to clarify play, have fun, and don't be so serious. Okay. And that is this card, Star Bathing, Light Body, Crystal Grid, Transmission, Activation. And you see there's an individual laying down. So yeah, there's really serious parts of spirituality that you have to take with very great understanding and very carefully. But then there's other parts where you can literally, like, it's a whole different world. You can feel different in a matter of no time with the help of just the universe. just the skies, just Gaia, just the stars, you know? Okay, so the very next card I'm going to pull is going to clarify, trust your path. All paths lead home, just so you know, but let's see what this one clarifies as, because that was beautiful. Right up, there's one that jumped over. Empathetic starseed. Energetic sovereignty, absorbing what's not yours. So, I see, like, in everything that you do, you are trying to fulfill your life's purpose, your divine purpose. I feel like your purpose here is to be an empathetic starseed or some type of one. Someone who basically absorbs all of the negative energy, probably in your family, something along those lines. Let me continue, because this is already really long and I didn't want to be this long, but I don't know what happened. Okay, so I'm going to assume that this one's for this card and this one is for this one. Forge, don't follow. Pave a new path. Be the leader you wish you had. So if you knew you would be supported, what would you do? You should forge, don't follow, pave a new path, be the leader you wish you had. Okay? And to clarify, don't play with me cards. And to clarify, Anna, grandmother of Jesus, seeding the light, laying foundations and divine plan, we have new earth. It's happening. Keep holding the vision. So you're part of the whole, like, awakening process. Look, cracked open, rock bottom, surrender to the alchemy of life. So you did just get out of a crazy this situation. It cracked you open. The alchemy of life, of your water from your cups getting mixed with your fire from your wands, getting entangled with your pentacles from, or your earth resources, your earthly situation, the ground, the sky, the flowers, whatever this pentacles are, resources are, that mixed with your mentality, all that mixed together, all of that working together, which is alchemy, all of these energies, all of these chemicals working together, which is alchemy. It's going to bring you to your next, like, level of self. Next level of self. You're all part of the, you're part of the bigger plan. We all are, but some of us have more important roles than others. Okay. Mars, the energy, planet of action. So you definitely have to start acting on these things. Capricorn, the very earthly energy, energy of strategy and responsibility, reputation, career, resources. Okay, and one more. Actually, two more. Did you hear me about to say two more? And two more came out. So we have Leo and Libra. So we have Mars, Capricorn, Leo, and Libra. We have a fire energy, earth energy, air energy, and fire again. So I'm feeling very much like Sagittarius. That's me, guys. You have a lot of fire energy here. So there should be a lot of doing happening. You need to take action on the situation with this person. Leave or stay and set boundaries. Like, you have to pick a struggle. That's it. Like, that's all I can say. Look at all these reversals. Like, this person is definitely, definitely not honeymooning. They're honey trapping. Be careful. All right, I'm going to pull the last couple cards. And then I'm going to hope that I didn't bore you to death. I'm going to ask for three of these. Nope. Try to hop out like that. Almost caught it. So you have, wow, you and your loved ones are safe. Cancer in a new moon. I need two more. Okay, we have this one, which is prosperity lies ahead. Taurus in new moon. So two new moons. This is like new energies coming in. A new energy, a new action, a new cycle, a new prosperity. That was too many. I just need one more. I'll take two, but I want one. Here we go. And surrender to the divine. Full moon. So yeah, the divine is very much the feminine energy, the moon. Okay. The cups, the water. You are very close to achieving your goal, gibbous moon. All right. I'm not really going to get into that at the moment. I'm going to touch on that a little more after I put these cards on top of them. Because apparently this is very much a relationship that is affecting you emotionally. This is not, I don't feel like this is a new thing. I feel like this is somebody who's just been here for a while. Like, I feel like you guys have been dealing with each other for quite some time. I feel like a lot of history is here. And yes, it does seem like that's the case. Okay, so this was stuck in the deck. It's soulmate. Yes, you, yes, this is your soulmate, like I said. Then we have here with wedding. Love yourself first. So wedding, the situation involves marriage. So maybe you will marry this person in the future, or you're you guys were married, are married. Love yourself first. Your self-respect makes your self-respect makes you more romantically attractive. The more that you set boundaries, the more that you love yourself, the more that you don't let people walk all over you, the more that you're attractive. And it just works both ways. Trust me, I know. And we have you deserve love. And that's very Sagittarius. Interesting. You are lovable. So what I'm feeling like is with the you and your loved ones will be safe with the new moon in Cancer, and this involves marriage. I feel like whatever situation you guys went through, separate, you'll be back together. It's fine. It's your soulmate. You guys will understand. It's going to hurt for a little while. I understand you're going to think you're going to lose this person. You're not going to lose this person. Okay? You have to love yourself first, and trust me, this person will be back, because you deserve the kind of love that you want, and they're going to give it to you. Prosperity lies ahead with you loving yourself. And once you surrender to the divine and realize that you deserve love, you are lovable, you will attract the love that is yours. I'm pretty sure it's going to be this person. No, I am not pretty sure. I don't know anything. I feel very strongly it's going to be this person. But possibly by the time you start loving yourself and fixing yourself and healing yourself, you might not even want this person. And they could possibly just be like the best man at your wedding or your maid of honor. Who knows? Oh boy, what a reading. Pile one, Piglet. Speaking of Piglet, I have a quote for you. Pile one, Piglet, and the sliced geoid. You're in a situation in which you need to get out of. This person is definitely a honey trap at the moment anyway. And what you need to do is definitely get out of there. Because if it was honeymoon, it would not be anything like this. Honeymoon is a couple months. A couple weeks, like a couple days is a real honeymoon, you know, a week at most. So this is a honey trap. You've been telling yourself that this is not working. You've been seeing that you're not getting the recognition that you want, but it's because you're not putting the effort in that you should anymore. Well, I can't say should, that you were anymore, because you feel the crap. You're like, nah, I'm not going to put all my energy into something that's not giving back to me. I feel like you're starting to see stuff. You're cracked open. That's it. That's all I can say. You're cracked open. Like, look, cracked glass. There's so many synchronicities here. I'm going to see if I can help you out here. Okay, so you have the two of these cups in reverse, and it's the 7 and the 8. Okay, the 7 and then the 8 drops down, and this is cracked. Okay, it's cracked open, and the 7 of cards is like no longer being deceived. The 7 of cups is like a card of deceiving, and it's in reverse. And then you have this 8 of wands in reverse. Nothing's been working right. And then the 4 of cups in reverse, like, you should have cut off this old energy. You're dealing with this old energy. And look at these two moons. And look, 2, injustice. Okay, so before we say goodbye, to wrap this up, you really need to let go of the situation. They'll be back. Use your Libra energy, the justice in the Libra. Same thing, okay? You have all this action. Put it into fruition. Do something. Act on how you're thinking and how you're feeling. Your first intuition, your first thought is always right because you have your mind in the right place. And I want to kind of take that back, but not. And the reason why I want to take that back is because I feel like there's someone who still has control of your mind somehow and still plays with your mind in some way. So I just think you should really listen to yourself. Look at what's happening in front of you and understand that once you love yourself first and you look, look, soulmate, look at this. The synchronicity's there. Look, listen what I'm telling you. Just listen what I'm telling you. You just get out of this situation right now. You have to. And it's and you might think you're going to lose this person. You're like 97%, 98. I almost want to say 99.9999, but I'm going to say 97%. Sure, you're not going to lose this person. Okay? Don't worry about it. Go separate yourself. Get yourself together. Ignore them calls. Like, I don't care if you're male or female. Get your life together. Be happy. Glow. And do it for yourself and not them. All right. So I did little sayings from each of the characters that, you know, were there. And this was Piglets. It was chosen through a dice roll. And let's see how it relates to your reading. Weeds are like flowers too, once you get to know them, Piglet. So I'm feeling like that does have a lot to do with your situation. I'm feeling like because you don't view yourself the way you should. Okay, you view yourself as like very ordinary. I mean, I feel like you know you're special, but the way you view yourself literally is just the opposite of how you know that you are. You know you're special, but you just treat yourself so very typical. Get to know yourself. Get to know that very dope, amazing, caring, intelligent, empathetic, growing, just amazing energy. And once you love yourself first, because you deserve love, you'll get everything that you want in love. This person's a honey trap. Don't fall for it. Take yourself on the honeymoon. Okay, I know this was really long. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please subscribe if you have not. And if you, and also if you liked it, please share with your friends. Please share my page. Or go on to my content and share one of my zodiac readings or a reading that you think your friend or family or a lover would like and send it to them. Please support. I very much appreciate you and you have a blessed day. Hey, hey, y'all. Those who picked pile two, welcome, welcome. I am excited to do Eeyore. A friend of mine picked Eeyore and I haven't even done it yet, but we'll see what the cards say. All right, so all of my friends and viewers who picked Eeyore, pile number two, or the Amazonite, this reading is for you, okay? Amazonite here is known for its healing properties. It is very, it's very much compared to it, to jade for its similarities. This is like a green color with white. Amazonite is named after the Amazon River in South America, said to be, it's said to get its green colors because most Amazonites that I've ever seen are green. And it's said that they get their color from the rainforest in Brazil and in South America. They crack and they chip and break very easy, also known as the Amazon stone. They can be also found in Russia, India, the United States, actually Ethiopia and Brazil, treasured by the Egyptians for its beauty and its healing properties, as stated. There's the story goes that Amazon women used this in their shields. They use it to heal the sick and cure the sick, and heal wounds. Okay, they also gave them to visitors, which is probably how it got around the world. Like I said, similar to jade, and it's also good for money, luck, and success. It's also called the gambler's stone. The gambler's stone because, you know, money, luck, and success, it is known for soothes the nervous system, soothes tense energy, and situates it. And it is a love enhancement stone. So this is a little busy stone. The green, I'm sure, is like abundance, money, Gaia, and love, because love is also green in tarot, as far as I know. We are going to begin this with the dice, and I'm going to roll this and get the energy of whatever element, problem, right solution, whatever the situation is, okay? So the four-sided die is the element, the six-sided die is the problem. All right, let's get an overall feel of the whole situation. Honey trap or honeymoon. Okay, so the fourth element is earth. So this is I feel like this is a situation where work possibly gets in the way. The physical, material, your home life possibly. There is definitely an energy of an emotional block here with the four. Okay. The six-sided die, I see the four here. But this four, stands for the problem, and the problem is diction. And diction is how a person talks is causing a problem. Speaking too much, speaking too little, being passive aggressive, which is one, is either yours or the other person's pet peeve. And that's why I was so careful, because I knew my hands are big. They were going to drop something. Someone's possibly using divisive or hateful language. It's like a manipulative energy. Okay. Let's just see a little more into this before I start pulling out your cards. So the action needed is the eight-sided die. And I looked at the five. It might have been... I looked at the five. That's what I saw. There was an eight there. And like, I'm tempted to make it an eight because of the two fours. But what I looked at originally was the five. Okay. So the five in the right action is the right livelihood. And this is to don't profit from harming others, long-term commitment to benefiting others. Take only what you need and give what you don't need. And ethical employment. With the five here on the eight-sided die, with the right livelihood being the right action, I feel as though your home and material, like the things that you have, your assets, of course they're important to you, but I feel as though, I don't know, not you, this person, I'm sorry. I feel as though this person gets like, yes, assets are important. Yes, material things are important. Yes, the home life is important, but I feel like, I don't know, they don't really respect it the way that they act like they respect the home life. Like, I feel like they break stuff and, you know, don't respect the home, is like disrespectful within the home, but yet expects order within the home. I don't know. That's the energy that I get. And I feel like this person uses money or like material resources, material wealth, material things like purses and such, sneakers, tires, a house, I don't know, anything material that's worth to someone, and uses it like leverage. Let's see what else is here. We have the difficulty level. Wow. I looked at the zero first. I've never really had that. So it is a very, very, very low difficulty situation because it's between 1 and 100 and this person has a 7 difficulty. So they are like, I don't know. It seems like they have like a personality disorder type thing. I'm not a doctor. I can't say, but it's like something's up with this person's head. This already, I feel like this person is a honey trap. Because like, I just, that's just crazy. Either that or they're giving up on your relationship. That's all I see. This is the one I wanted to re-roll. And this is a time of year. 2. And that's February. That is, that would still be winter. So it's February, winter. It's 2 p.m. So 2 p.m. might be an important time. February might be an important time. What was the other one I was going to say? Pisces, or the other sign, not Aries. Capricorn. That's what it's Capricorn. Sorry guys. Okay. And, I'm just feeling like this person is just very not for anybody. Honestly, it seems like they're just, floating through life. I feel like they talk to you in a disrespectful manner, but yet it's like the end of the world let you say something a certain way. You know what I'm saying? Even if they even think you are. Look at that face. Look at Eeyore's face. You see his face? I feel like that's your face all the time. And the Amazonite has the strength of like success and money and luck and healing, connected to the nervous system. So I feel like this person, money, there's something involved with money with them. Also, there is something involved with like addiction to something. I don't know what the addiction is. It can be like to gambling, to porn, to, you know, anything. I just feel like there's a need to enhance love and neutralize the energy, just like the Amazonite does. Lastly, I want to say this is a 4, but I've looked at like every number on here. So what is the lesson here? 1, the Magician. Okay. So the lesson here is be careful what you do. Okay. Because this person, they are very dangerous. And not, I don't mean that in like a killer type way. I mean, I don't know. But I mean that in like, they can easily win you over and pull you under if you're not careful. They have very convincing ways about them. But they're very passionate. But yet their anger is quick. Mood swings, I feel. I feel like mood swings. All right. Home is a big deal to them. Material things are a big deal to them. Of course, resources to everybody to an extent. Okay. And the physical things are important. That's what's important to them. And they don't like to be talked to any type of way, but they will talk any type of way and use their money to like get out of it, or use their resources, like their good, their livelihood, to get out of the situation. Possibly like playing the victim. And it's like so easy. They have a 7. I've never seen that in a reading before. I've never seen that in a reading that low. Never. February, last month, or February of 2019, 2020, I mean. Okay. And the magician, yeah, they're like at a point where they're very, very dangerous, so be careful. Okay, I spent a lot of time on that. I'm going to move on and just start pulling the cards that I pulled out for you. So we have three of my Osho Zen tarot cards. Wow, that jumped out my hand. And here they are. You have Postponement in reverse, the Four of Swords in reverse. So I'm feeling like there's a need for you to slow down, okay? This is usually speaking of you needing to... Actually, I feel like you're needing to not slow down. Hold on. Yeah, slow down. Slow down with the outside world, the outside energies, and focus on self. All right? Ooh. So you have the Four of Swords in reverse, the Nine of Swords in the upright. And I'm going to put this over here because there's just simply more room. No rhyme or reason. The Two of Wands in the reversed. So, here's what I feel. This person's energy is making you like not focusing on the right things. You're missing possibilities. You're missing so many possibilities. Look at your face. Tell me that's not hilarious. Look. He's looking like, bruh. That's funny. Okay. Here we go. Yes. I feel like it's only gonna lead to sorrow, or is just hiding you from your sorrow. Like this energy, this situation, it might feel very beautiful because of the passion, because of the intensity, but either you're using it to cover up a sorrow that you have that you're like running from, or it's going to cause you sorrow. It's moving too fast. You need to slow down. You're missing out on a lot of possibilities because this energy is just there. They want to be everywhere in your life, in your home, they just want to be all over your everything. I feel like they might buy you things and like to see you in it, or possibly if you wear it, they're like, yeah, you know, I remember when I bought you that kind of energy. Okay, we have one oracle card, and it is the 44. You can't go back to yesterday. Be in the present. Okay. Then we have three. Is this three? Oh, no, this is four. Four of the Starman Tarot deck cards. So it says you can't go back to yesterday, be in the present. I feel like you're doing a lot of reminiscing. You've learned a lot from the past, but you're still kind of living there instead of taking what you've learned and moving forward. Yeah, Two of Cups. There's a healing relationship out there for you. And you're very focused on one that is over, or one that you're in that is over. Like, you just think about when you guys first got together kind of energy. The Justice card. Okay. Heart and mind. Are you being fair? Are you being honest with yourself and others? Are you being logical? Are you being emotionally intelligent? Just so much. Now, it's crazy because you have the healing relationship, the healing energy of a relationship, the coming together, the union of two emotional energies in a healing way, or for the healing purpose. And then you have heart and mind in hand. So in order to heal properly, you need your heart and your mind in your hand. You can't go back to yesterday. See, it's just like you want the wrong parts of this relationship and this situation. This guy, I don't want to say he doesn't care, because he does care, but the writing's on the wall and you're not seeing it. Like, this is a healing relationship. Could be karmic, could be twin flame. It all depends on how you handle the situation. It can't be like it was. It's not going to be, there is no going back to normal. I feel like I have to say that. There's no going back to normal. Now you have to think logically and with compassion. Not emotion like love, like, because compassion is love, but not like that romantic-y, you know, mushy family, oh, that's my mom, oh, that's my whatever love. No, it has to be like a compassionate love, human to human kind of love. A logical and human to human kind of love. All right. The strength card. Nice. This is the Leo energy and this is the Libra. You guys were together in the last reading. That's weird. So with the strength card being with the healing relationship card, the Two of Cups, I'm feeling very much like, wow, two lions, two people for the Two of Cups and the heart and mind, two sides of the scale. Very, very interesting to me, the Two of Possibilities. Yeah, I feel like you missed out on a lot of possibilities. Postponement is 2 and 2. Huh. Okay, so let me, the Ace of Wands. Swords in the reverse. Okay. Are you lying to yourself or others? Or this person is definitely lying to you. And I feel like you have the strength to either get through this situation or you are getting through the situation. You're not letting, or you shouldn't let the past, or you're not letting the past affect how you pursue your future. And your, things that happen to you, it's not like you're like, oh well, this happened to me, that's why I'm this way, and I don't want to do that, and I'm just not going to ever do that in my life because this happened to me once. Like, I don't feel that energy with you. You have the strength card, and if you are that way, you shouldn't be that way ever, because it's gonna take over your life and ruin it. And with this can't go back to yesterday, I feel like you want that very bad. Like, ugh, I feel like you want this situation so bad. Where's my wand? With the can't go back to yesterday, with the Justice in the upright and the Ace of Swords in reverse, I'm feeling as though either you're lying to yourself about what you deserve or what you're getting, like, karmic-wise. I feel like you're lying to yourself or others, possibly. Or someone's very much lying to you about something, saying you deserved it, or, you know, saying, oh, you didn't deserve that. But those people who say those things, those aren't genuine people who say you don't deserve something. If someone ever says, like, oh, well, I would never do that to you, run, okay? That's all I can tell you. So I feel like there's a falsehood here with your Justice card. Like, excuses being made, justifying things. Exactly. That's exactly what I mean. You're justifying the past to get through this relationship? Huh. So you're sad, stuck, postponed, because you're moving too fast in a relationship that you shouldn't be in, and you're missing possibilities of other great things, and you're justifying things of the past. You're justifying something of the past, in order to feel better about, whatever this is. Okay. Okay, so we're going to clarify these energies to just get a better answer and just keep on moving. Keep it going. I have lots of stuff to do today, and I procrastinated so bad. The Moon in the upright. Okay, that makes sense. I found out today that that crab, or that crustacean, I guess it would be called, I'm not sure, is... it stands for protection. Yes. So I feel like you did some introspection, right? Getting in touch with your higher self. That's where the strength card comes from, I believe so. And getting in touch with your higher self, healing. Yes. And I feel as though, okay, you got the Wheel of Fortune in the reversed position. And that's, you know, things are not as good as you'd like them to be right now. Okay. But please still keep that positive energy. This is the energy of going after, obsessing after something in an unhealthy way. And I feel like if it's this individual or like a relationship of feeling that you're looking for, find that within yourself, like you are with the Moon. And don't let it get to you or affect how you love or handle yourself in the future, like the Strength card. Okay. I want to warn you because I feel like, I don't know if you're being reckless. There's a difference between taking risks and being reckless. And I need you to just take note of that. There's chaos. It's chaotic. It's unorganized. It is, all the wrong situations, circumstances, and such. Okay. Let me get one more. With the Hermit in the upright. So it's looking like you need to, or you will be soon, a Hermit, and the World in the reverse. So you're not ending a cycle. Like, you're supposed to be ending a cycle and beginning another one currently, and it's not happening. This Hermit situation is good. The fact that you got the Hermit in the upright, that means that you're doing, like, really doing some introspection. You see the Moon here with the Hermit, who I believe is a Druid, by the way, and the Moon card with the, of course, the Moon. Okay. I am just going to continue with my Akashic cards. Is that what I wanna do? Is that what I wanna do? Yep, that's what I wanna do. Okay. I know, guys, I'm weird. It's okay. I understand. You can say it. All right. So for the Akashic cards, these are like the Akashic records, your whatever's in your brain, like whatever's in your mind's eye, the distant memories and the distant energies or your higher self, whatever they have been through or remember, like, you have access to those things and they help you throughout this lifetime. So let's see what this Akashic records, Uriel in the Sphinx. So you have the 21 Arcana, Uriel and Sphinx, and look, yet another Moon. I don't know if you can see. Then we have the Four of Keys, clearing the way. Okay. We have the Six of Scrolls in reverse, the Sands of Time. Okay. I have a feeling that this is going to lead me here, up here. All right. And I feel like this is going to tell me something special. Okay. And finally, we have the Four of Forces, spring and autumn. I've never seen this card. I get summer and winter a lot. I've never gotten spring and autumn. So this is the Four of Cups, basically. Four of Cups. I want to say Four of Pentacles, Four of, I want to say air. Well, not Four of, but like, this is the air sign. And I want to say the red is the fire sign. Okay, but I'm not sure because I really didn't pay too much attention to finding out which was which. It doesn't really say in the book. Okay. With the 21 Arcana, Uriel, and the Sphinx, there's a big job lying ahead for you. And it's probably the hardest job that you're ever going to have to do. And it has a lot to do with what I showed you. The moon. You got the Moon three times in this reading quickly. So all I have to really say is, like, look within yourself. I feel like this isn't even really going to be a long reading because this person seems to be like the your kryptonite, as my cousin would say. Somebody that just, like, makes you weak. It is indeed a honey trap. Now, will it be forever? I don't know. Let's just continue. With the 21 Euro and the Sphinx, this card shows that it is time for you to do the most important work, probably the hardest work of your life. The digging and inner discovery that takes you to the deepest self, okay, and deepest power. Even the great Sphinx had to be dug out many times from the blowing desert sands that buried it up to its neck. And you must dig diligently too. You may have to chip away at some rock-like substances of your old beliefs and histories so you can get the truth inside, but don't worry, you already have begun. And you have made considerable inroads. There's also someone here to help you, Uriel. His name means God of Fire. You can work directly with your meditations with the Archangel for self-understanding, transformation, and guidance. Now, there's more. I'm just not going to read it. And I mean, it's basically saying, look for a teacher for understanding, transformation, and guidance, and you can ask the Archangel Uriel to help you find this teacher. And it's a very important relationship that you should have with this teacher. And I just want to say, I don't pray to anything or invoke anybody or anything. Like, I don't do any of that. I just pray to God. So I personally, I don't even want to say that to, you know, commune, meditate with Archangel. I don't know about that because I don't believe in doing it myself. I don't know if it's right or wrong. I just don't believe in doing it myself because I just believe in the only person you should be praying to or talking to is God. Maybe, I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. Anyway, so the next card, being that you have to do this inner introspection, the Hermit doing introspection, the Moon doing introspection, protecting yourself with the Crab, like the Cancer card. Oh, that's so interesting. I just caught on to that. Okay, the Four of Keys in the upright. I thought it was in reverse. No, it's in the upright. Okay, the Four of Keys in the upright is clearing the way. This card is a strong signal that it is now time. I'm going to put my glasses on. That's what time it is. It is time for me to just put my glasses on and grow up. Oh, crap. I'm sorry. I moved everything. All right. The Four of Keys says, clearing the way says, this card is a strong signal that now it's time to take significant action to remove an obstruction in your way. Oh my gosh. It may be in your personal life, in a relationship, at work, or in a creative project. You must be clear-headed so you can be sure to temper your actions with calm and forethought. Be sure to temper your actions with calm and forethought. If you are too urgent and excitable, you may waste your energy or even cause damage. Mm-mm-mm. We don't want that. And that kind of lines up with this obsessive energy here. That sounds a lot like this too excitable here passage. You may waste energy or even cause damage. On the other hand, if you are overly gentle or cautious, you won't clear the way completely. Be determined and strong as you work to remove the obstacle that blocks your steps. With time and attention, the way to your dreams will come true. Okay. Now, it doesn't say any special message here, but it leads right up to this Wheel of Fortune in the reverse and the Chariot in reverse. And the Chariot is the determination and the strong willpower and the victory and the will for victory and the winning. And that's what that energy is in the upright. You have it in the reverse with the Wheel of Fortune in reverse. That's the obstruction you need to move. What are you so hung up on? And I believe it's that energy of the other person. I believe they have you all bumblefubbed. Okay. So interesting. So here with this Six of Scrolls, the Sands of Time, you have it in reverse. And in reverse, this means you have more time than you think. So there's no need to hurry. There's no need to rush. The sun is rising in the east on a new day. And the hourglass is now full, or not now full, is full. The task at hand may require more research and follow through. So take all the time that you need. You may even have the opportunity to investigate further or to connect with others who can help. So take a breath. You've got plenty of time to explore. Okay. This inner discovery that you're supposed to be doing, don't rush it. Do not rush this inner discovery. You need to get through this inner discovery and this, you need to get through this in order to be in healthy relationships and to be able to recognize unhealthy ones. And I mean in any aspect of your life, love, romantically, familial, career-wise, whatever. I feel like that's definitely the next step in your process, your journey. I feel like that's a very close, like you are on a journey and in many different places. And this is four different kinds of cards. That's incredible. Four different suits in a card of, in a deck of five suits. You got one of each. Okay. So here with the Four of Forces in the upright, this is spring autumn. And this card indicates that this could be a very, very creative period for you. When someone's going through an emotional situation, trying to figure things out, needing to be distracted, needing to pour themselves into things, the creativity just kind of pours out with the emotion. That's just the way that it is. Emotion brings out creativity. It makes you imagine different things and feel different things and think different ways, okay? Take action in creative projects or work-related endeavors that require more time and attention. That the work that you do now could yield great rewards later. Make sure you engage in this extra activity with joy and optimism. You are always planting your energy into the Akashic records of your life. So as you work toward your goals, remember to plant hope, happiness, along with the actions that you take. That makes so much sense, like for a message for myself. Like, wow. Makes so much sense. You are on a journey of self-discovery, spirituality, self-love, self-growth, self-discipline. What is the words I'm looking for? I'll just say personal growth. That's it. Personal growth. You are at a stage of personal growth, and I feel like either this person is... I feel like this person might not even be involved. I feel like they added to it, but they didn't start it. I feel like they are something that's in the way. Yeah, you have like this duality about you. You have like, you're so special. And you know you are. You just don't see yourself that way sometimes. All right. So far, Eeyore. Wow. Let me get Eeyore because he's just like sitting back here. And I didn't want him to get in the way, but here you go. Eeyore. Great. It's not bad. Yes, this person's energy is like stopping you up. And you're getting a little reckless. Like a little unlike yourself. You're like obsessive. And not like obsessing over a person, but like obsessive over situations, dates, fulfilling needs, fulfilling your own needs, your kids' needs, whatever the case may be. Like, you just have an energy of in a hurry, basically in a rush. Okay, so what we're gonna do now is just pull 2-3 energies and put them right here, and from manifest your soulmate, what you need to do to manifest your soulmate. Wow. Okay. It is the you are moving into a steady and reliable path, but you have that in reverse. So what you need to do is move on, it seems, onto a steady and reliable path, not one of volatile one, not one of mixed emotions and like a roller coaster of emotions. That's blocking you from manifesting your soulmate. Okay? You need to be on a clear path, a steady and clear one. Don't be afraid of losing someone who doesn't want you. Okay. Say less. Listen, people only don't want you, and this is male or female, I don't care that it's just it's a male or a female. If someone doesn't want you and you stop wanting them, watch how fast they want you. People only, usually, unless like there's cases where somebody just doesn't want the other person anymore for some reason, and it has nothing to do with anything that the other person can do to fix it. But if you just like are dealing with a situation that's very roller coaster, back and forth, push pull, like if you stopped talking to that person or stop answering their call so fast or just like not caring or not showing you care anymore, watch what changes. Okay, one more. Wow. Follow your heart's desires and manifest that out of your life. And that's another thing that you're refusing to do. Wow. Let things come and go. Stay calm. Don't let anything disturb your peace and carry on. I'm not even going to say any more about these cards because I don't need to. I mean, if someone's not afraid of you, losing you, like you're just, I feel like you're just so stuck. That's why it's not a steady path, because every time this person comes back, you like jump right back in. Okay, let me look at my, angel answers? Angel answers possibly? Right, let's look, it's looking like you have to do introspection. Forget this. This other person is basically an obstacle. Like, they don't care about losing you. They are in your way, clearing the way. Looking within yourself, self-discovery, not rushing into the situation. Like, I just feel like you just want to fill a, like a whole kind of thing, and it's just not working out. Everything between this moon in the upright and this hermit in the upright, looking within yourself and looking within yourself, basically isolation to look within yourself, is reverse. Chaos, confusion, and disappointment. That's all that is. Okay. Here, Pleiades, double mission, channeling and uplifting humanity. So I feel as though maybe you have a gift, but you definitely uplift humanity. Maybe your gift is just you're good at talking to people. People might like to really talk to you, and they might really like to come to you for advice. And I feel like you're very, like, not a hater. Let's just put it like that. Soul family, calling your tribe. You don't have to do it alone. Okay, so harmony. Look, a family, a group, and there's a family right here, two people. Soul family. It's very fluid, very ancient, very old soul family that is very harmonious and synchronized, connected. Okay, let me see what this is. Inner temple, devotion, tune into the portal of your heart. All right, now with these cards, I'm going to pull these starseed cards and see what each one has for each of those cards. Okay, so what do the starseed cards have to say for these? So the Pleiades card, double mission, channeling, uplifting humanity. What do we have here? We have bigger picture. Bigger picture thinking, Pleiades energy. Oh, wow. Visionary and inspired. I cannot make this up. Wowzer. Okay. I'd like to get clarity for the soul family. All right. So we see clearly you have Pleiades energy all over the place. If you have not started stepping back to look at the bigger picture of, you know, helping humanity, because that's what you're here for, then you really need to step back and take a look at the fact that you're here to help humanity. Pleiades energy starseed very much. Okay, give me some confirmation or some clarity for soul family. Call your tribe in, and you don't have to do it alone. Okay. Oh, wow. Oh, Eeyore. Wow. And you saw how he fell over and jumped in? Look, jump in. Andromedon energy, adventure, say yes. So I feel like you are very, very close to your soul family. It's just you are not jumping in. I don't want to have that many cards. Okay. Temple energy, devotion, tune in, and portal of your heart. Let's see what clarity we can get on that. Okay. Wow. Oh my goodness, that's so interesting. That was so crazy. When I do readings, I have a scarf on, so I have turmeric, a piece of turmeric, like up near my temple, and it just kind of like flew out of my scarf. How? No idea. But this is the card that you got for inner temple, and wow, you almost got this for here, and I was like, too many cards. A new earth is happening. Keep hold of your vision. Devotion, tune into the portal of your heart. So even when it gets frustrating and you no longer want to feel this way of just loving and forgiving, living like I feel Christ, that's what this is. Inner temple, soul family. It's very spiritual. I see a lot of spheres here. Orbs. You see orbs a lot. Eye of God or the nebula. It's a I forget what it's called. It's a dying star in another galaxy over. A new earth. You know, a new earth speaks of the after the day of judgment. All right. Star keepers. Wow. Cosmic ancestors seed the light by staying grounded. Wow. I'm going to get one more simply because these are buzzing right now. Okay. And that card is I Remember. Wow. Oh my gosh. Soul plan, the fated life versus destiny life. So basically it's saying you planned for all of this to happen. This is happening all according to your plan. Wow. Forge, don't follow. Pave a new path. Be the leader you wish you had. Okay. So with that, I say if you're gonna deal with this honey trap, you need to be on your P's and Q's because they are gonna try you and they are gonna try to play you. I have no doubt about that, and I'm not a fortune teller. I'll tell you that with quickness. But what I can tell you is this individual, this energy that I'm feeling, no good. Okay. So I'm gonna grab my numine all my cards fell. Oh, boy. I'm about to do some clarifying. There we go. Libra, the idealist and energy of harmony and balance. This is an air sign. Very particular and specific. A people-pleasing person, but they are people too, so they please themselves, as bad as that sounds, but you know what I mean. I feel like you might have like a judgmental spirit, so you definitely need to look within yourself, okay? Oh, the Four of Keys in reverse, I mean in the upright with the quincunx, irritates, puzzles, mystifies, complicates. So this clearing that you need to do with this complexities transforms, educates. Okay, so this is a lesson. You removing this situation from your way is a lesson that you're learning currently. And Jesus. Okay, the 11th house, the edge, which is Pisces house, or it might be Aquarius house. Aquarius for sure. friendship, group, creativity, community, humanity, tribe, festivals, discovery, and common goals and such. I feel like you can use those things as part of finding your innermost self and chipping away at those rocks of who you are, or who you've built over time. Not who you are, who you've built on yourself over time. Thank you, Jesus. It's made you into this person that is very balanced with the Libra, very harmonious and whatnot, caring and very, I want to say sacred, but I don't know if that's explaining it the way that I want to explain it, but that's how I feel in a certain way, if that makes sense. Looking within yourself, you really have to start chipping away. And you're chipping away at this obstacle that is in your way of finding inner self with the two moons up here. And look, it's pointing up. And the complexity is something that's really getting to you. But it's something you're going to learn from. And don't rush it, because you have time to heal. You will love again. You will enter relationships again. You will have friendship and best friendships again. You just have to work on this first. Very heavy on the Aquarius energy. Very, very heavy on the Aquarius energy. I feel like this is very innovative energy. Innovative social energy. Okay. And that's in the scrolls. So stop. Like, what do I want to say? Stop. You're taking a lot serious. Even when it comes to looking within yourself, you don't have to take everything so serious. You still can live life and have fun and do those things that you love in a different way, in a more advanced or more expanded way. Okay, the edge, discoveries, experiments, and group creativity. Like, you don't got to do this alone. You don't have to do introspection alone the whole time. You can have a support system. Okay, so the four forces, let's see what that's all about. Wow. No, thank you. I'm not taking all of them. Thanks, but no thanks. Okay. Okay, well, I'll take two, sure. The North Node, which is your destiny, wow, and the Capricorn, which is the boss. So this is basically through life, through practice, through your situations, through your karmic, reincarnations, through the universe and all that you've prescribed to get here, because you do remember that you planned this all. You're turning into the badass that we know you are, because you have all these centuries and all these layers and layers of wisdom, knowledge, and love, and trust, and all this stuff like layering you. It's just under these the sand in the rock like material. Okay. You can be boss status. Your destiny is to be the boss. That's it. You know what? Hold on. I was about to grab cards, but I'm not. Okay. Because we already have the one more deck to pull from. And still down here. I do want to clarify that in some way, though, for sure. All right. Yeah, it is in your destiny to be the boss. And it being on top of the four forces, it's time for creativity. It's a period of creativity to make the most of the situation that you're enduring, that you're dealing with. Whether it's good, bad, ugly, halfway, you've been going through it, it's brand new, it's fresh. Your boss status right now, the way you're dealing with it, okay? Okay. I want to get a little more information on bigger picture and Pleiades. And I remember, wow. Okay, Sun is on the bigger picture thinking and Pleiades, essence, energy, awareness. So you are Pleiades energy. Distinction, childness, ego, individuality, self-sufficiency, shine, heartbeat, father, honor, creativity. Tap into your inner being. Just like this card is saying, just like that card is saying. Okay, hold on. I remember. And then you have the Venus energy, the planet of love. It's beauty, harmony, romance, charm, receiving, value, sensitivity, luxury, wealth, indulgence, taste, style, all the beautiful things, attraction, adoration. Whew, yes, I like it. I feel like once you start remembering who you are, going down your proper path, manifesting the heck out of your life, it's going to be a beautiful experience. Okay, let's get clarity on soul family and jump in. All right, Taurus. And this is the bombshell. This is a grounded, earthy, down-to-earth kind of very... territorial, possessive, particular, just like the other energy. I want to say, like, has to get things a certain way, their way, particular in that type. These individuals, though, they're very reliable. Very reliable, very practical, very steadfast, fertile, tactical, ample, worthy, ripe, pleasure seeking, and sensatious. Solid. Yes, I love it. And these people, they're patient, they're loyal, and they're deliberate. So jump in. They got your back. They got your back. And then you have this still under here after I shuffled, which is Jupiter, Sagittarius, Sagittarius planet. And it's a planet of expansion and expansion of your beliefs, of your wisdom, of your travels and such. Okay, I'm going to get clarity on inner temple and a new earth. Okay. Okay, we have two. We have the semi-sextile and the square. So it's two different aspects we have here. We have encourages, sees the potential in and clarifies. And we have creates tension, stalls, and sets off alarms. It's like working together and totally like fighting. I'm going to, because that's what the inner temple and the new earth. Okay, I'm feeling like you're being maybe possibly a little rebellious against your destiny. I don't know. I do not know. But what I do know is I'm about to pull an energy or two for this. What is this about the challenge and the allowing? Ooh, wow, that's a lot. Let me see. One, two. If it's only two, but I could have sworn I seen like mad of them fall. Get out of here. Did they fall in here? Did they fall in the garbage? Really? That is a. I could have sworn there was more than this, but I'll take this and I'll just look. Oh, here they are. I knew at least one of them. The other one could be anywhere. And that's how I always find extra energies for people on my floor when I'm doing readings. It's like always extra energy. Anyway, you have the Mars energy here with the semi-sextile and the square. And that's on top of inner temple and a new earth. So Mars, which is a planet of action. Pisces, which is a very fluid energy of spirituality. And Jupiter. You got Jupiter again, planet of expansion of knowledge and wisdom and travel and love and hobbies and interests and all types of stuff. Uranus, and that's, no, that's not, that's not their planet, I'm sorry. Uranus is a planet of revolution and technology and revolts and such. Okay, and last, definitely not least, because they're probably my favorite cards, I'm going to pull for you my Moonology and then the Eeyore saying to see how it goes with your reading. I don't know if I, like, mentioned that, but yeah, there's that. Wow, what an interesting reading. You are most definitely a starseed, okay? You most definitely have soul family, probably a Taurus or some kind of earth energy, but I'm feeling Taurus. right, first and foremost, we are going to clarify the Venus energy over there with the I remember and all of that. All right, we have a new romantic cycle begins. A new moon in Libra. Libra. Look at that. Look at that. So you're currently, it doesn't look like you were on the right path, but look, things are about to turn around in love. Okay? In love, baby. Because this not manifesting your life, not being on a steady and reliable path, and you know, being afraid of losing someone who doesn't love you, you weren't living the best life. But then you started to remember who you were, or you're starting to. And in love, you started leading with love and remembering that you deserve love. And a new romantic cycle begins with the new moon in Libra. All right. All right. So I want to get some clarity on these two and these, let's see, Libra, looking at inner self, something's in the way. Okay. Let's get some clarity here. Let's see what happens. Too many. All right. I'll take less. Than that. Okay, here it is. Virgo, a time to give rather than to take, new moon in Virgo. Okay, so start giving to yourself more rather than taking from yourself. Because you give from your own bank of like energy and love and like stuff that you ain't, and nobody ever fills it back up. Except for you. Like, how fair is that? I'm trying to get some more, rather give time to give rather than take, and nothing is yet in stone. Okay, so this obstacle, you know, it's not in stone with the mutable moon. It feels, it can be moved, it can be changed. This energy of giving can be changed. The energy is gaining momentum, waxing moon. So, the energy of the North Node, the energy of creativity, the energy of destiny and boss. Look at that. Really, really, really cool. Is it's gaining momentum. And I feel like it's going to be attracting that love that you deserve, because you're going to be happy and radiating love. Right? Oh, there we go. We actually have a couple. So one. Yeah, we'll take these, and that's cool. So clarifying these over here, adding a little more information to it for us. The being in the Pleiades, we have, oh, I have more in my hand than I thought. I didn't see this little sneaky one here that just fell, and I'm just gonna use this as an extra energy because it fell out of my hand. Or maybe it was supposed to be here because it fell. Wow, Leo. Confidence is key to your success. New moon in Leo. Okay. You can be who you want to be. You don't have to be afraid. You don't have to worry about what anybody else is thinking. You don't have to worry about anybody else's approval. None of that. You don't have to worry about bringing anybody with you or offending anybody. If you're leading in love the way I feel like you are, you'll be fine. You have bring love into the situation, new moon in Aquarius. So like I said, love, lead in love. Listen, new moon in Aquarius, like lead in love. You have new romantic love coming in. Bring love into all situations and you're going to attract it. Don't let your pride get in the way. Again, Leo, full moon in Leo. And finally, personal issue reaches resolution. Full moon in Cancer. Yes, I am loving it. Would you guys hate me if I pulled romance cards? Because since there's romance coming, clearly there's romance coming, I would like to pull some romance cards. I was not expecting to, but romance is coming. It says it right there, guys. I know, it's so long. This one's going to be like almost 3 hours. Watch. Oh, terrible. Terrible. All right. So let's look into this romance here. Okay. I'm excited. What do you got going on here? I crack myself up. I definitely need some more in-person friends, and I promised I wouldn't do that anymore, and there I was doing it again, and I truly apologize, guys. I know that's gotta be annoying. Okay. We have Love Yourself First. Oh my God. That's all this is saying. Love yourself first. Your self-respect makes you more romantically attractive. I've been saying that. I've been saying that, but okay. Let's see what else comes up. Nothing. Okay. Okay, this one. This is make the effort. Great love is worth taking the step you're guided to take. If you feel pulled towards someone or you feel like the connection is real and not happening too fast, but the connection is real, make the effort. Don't be afraid. You're going to miss out if you do. Okay, this is like halfway. So true love. Wow. This is the romance of a lifetime. So I feel like the situation, like it's going to come and you're going to have to put some effort into it. And that's something you just not wanting to do. But if you love yourself first and come to that, like what this Uriel and the Sphinx is saying, what the moon is saying, what the freaking Hierophant is saying, like basically your whole reading, love yourself first and it'll be so easy to find or attract love because it'll come to you, like, and you'll know. Wow. Okay. Okay. Yeah. Okay. There we go. Wow. Isn't that insane? Okay, so I'm just kind of like all over the place because these cards are crazy. Okay, so you have calling in your soulmate, like I just said. Your prayers, affirmations, and visualizations help bring you together. I just said it. And even more interesting, you have honeymoon. So enjoy the bliss of holiday time together. But that's not all, my friend, because look at the bottom deck card, retreat. Does that not scream honeymoon? It's time to disconnect from the world. The reason why this energy of the male disappeared so fast is because you had a new one all lined up with love. I want to read yours quote that I rolled the dice and picked. Like, literally rolled a dice and picked a reading. And his says, most likely lose it again anyway, Eeyore. Wow. I feel like this is so much your energy when it comes to love. Like, you're just like, is it even worth it? Should I even do? That's probably why you're watching this. You're scared. Most likely lose it again anyway. That's very, very crazy. I think that's why you held on so tight to that energy. I loved the reading. I really did. This was a good one. Let go of whatever you're holding on to. Let go. You don't need it. You don't need it. It looks like the right thing, but it's the wrong thing. And nothing set in stone. Give more to yourself. Start chipping away. Like, you need to do things different. Bring more love into the situation. Live with love. Don't be proud, even if you have all rights to be. Like, when people say you shouldn't be or don't be, it's not because, like, you don't have the right to be. It's just the universe and the way things work. Okay, so you're definitely reaching a resolution very soon with the full moon in Cancer. And the energy of greatness is building as you further yourself away from that energy and build your energy up and attract this energy because you're no longer being emptied by that energy. Okay, so pile number two, that was amazing. I hope you liked your reading. I hope this was not too long. And you have a wonderful rest of your day, afternoon, evening. Hello to those of you who picked pile number three with Winnie the Pooh. Winnie the Pooh has with him citrine. It is a citrine stone. Citrine crystal is known to increase creativity, to protect against negative energy, activate your intuition, help manifest abundance and success, which is very important. It inspires and encourages us to share. promotes happiness and joy, raises self-esteem and confidence, encourages positive attitudes, and helps with communication, not to mention it helps with blood circulation. Got all that? If I'm not mistaken, it's the Leo's, it's associated with Leo and Virgo. I know Leo for sure, but I'm not positive about Virgo. Okay. So my Winnie the Pooh pile three chooses, who chose the citrine, which this is a citrine crystal quartz because it has, or citrine clear quartz because it has the clear on the other side, and the citrine is this associated with fire. Okay. Let's put it right here, because this is where we're gonna put poo. Okay, so pile three, Winnie the Pooh pickers, citrine pickers. Is this person a honey trap? Or is this honeymoon energy? And these dye, different sided dye, are gonna give us pretty much an energy of what's going on with this situation. Okay. One always falls. I'm going to say that's a 10. Okay. So, very first of all, we have the one energy here. And the one energy is air, if I'm not mistaken. And air is mental, academic, communication, and anxiety. Okay. The second one, the six-sided die, is the problem. So what is the problem? The problem is the plot. And what that means, here, let me put this down. So you got two ones. Wow. So far. Okay. So what that means is there's drama. There's conflict. There's things that are outside of your control. And there's lots and lots of change. Next, we are looking at the action needed, which is on the eight-sided die. And I saw the seven first. The action needed refines the problem. Okay. And the seventh action needed is the right mindfulness. Don't make things out to be more than what they are. See them for what they are. Know life is in transition. And don't define the self by the external transitory states, which makes so much sense with the plot being your second die of drama, conflict, things outside of your control, and change. Your life is going through stuff. You got to put yourself in the right mindset. Okay, you're going through things. That's life. It's not fair. It's not an excuse, but that's the reason. And you have to understand that you're just trying to survive and navigate through this like realm that you are clueless about. If things are out of your control and things are changing, don't make them out for more or less than what they are, and see them for exactly what they are. Like exactly what they are. Because when you know why something is or why something does, it's easier to accept. Okay. I'm feeling like it's a lot of it is like really all in your head. And if it's, and if even if it's a legit fear, worry, or whatever, you overthink it, you marinate it, you tenderize it, you just like live in the situation. And that might be the problem. It's probably seeping through your communication, not communicating clearly, not communicating at all possibly. Like having a lot of anxiety because of another situation that or like external situations that are affecting you in some way. Okay. The right mindfulness. You have to understand, you know, we all go through things, and the more you stand up and try to be strong and try to, you know, get past these things and don't, and live like a blameless future from now on, like a blameless one. You know, everything happens for a reason. It's not saying that people shouldn't be blamed for their problems. Like, it is their fault, but it's no excuse to ever like live in the past or be a certain way because of somebody or because of situations. Very anti-strength card. Okay, so the difficulty of the situation for you is 8, for them is 80. Well, it's 80 something. It's looking like it wants to be a 40, but like it was definitely 80. 84. It's a 84. Okay. All right. Now let's see when this, around when this took place, like the timing. It would be the 10th month, which would be October. It can be the 10, like a completion of something, like the end of school, the end of church, the end of like a day, like the completion of something, the end of training, anything like that. It can also be, since you have so many, well, that's 1, 2, 3, yeah, literally like cut in half even between both. Oh, actually, no. It is 10 a.m. So October is important. 10 a.m. is important. Maybe October is important. Maybe 10 a.m. is important. Maybe fall, possibly very important. I feel like, oh, let me put this down. Okay. I get all caught up just like rolling it in my fingers and just, I feel like Godfather sitting back in my chair, just swinging back and forth. Fall can speak of a time of harvest, making preparations for winter and celebrating your accomplishments. Okay. 10 a.m. is work-related, stress and out of control. So this person has so much, like, this whole situation has just like so much energy on it. So much stress. It feels like everything is like out of control. It's chaotic almost. Let's see. Lesson is number 15. Number 15 is the devil. Yeah, the devil. Materialism as bondage. Enjoy pleasure without becoming victim to it. Pleasure seeking as escapism. Okay. Don't become too self-indulged. Don't become too addicted. Like, I can't say don't become too addicted. Be careful, because you may become addicted to things. And it doesn't have to be a drug. It doesn't have to be alcohol. It can be anything. But too much of anything is not good for you. Except for God. There's never too much of that. Or oxygen. Oh, yes, there is too much of oxygen, I guess. Okay, God is the only thing. Don't get tied down by material things. Don't get tied down by material things that you see, even if they don't own you, or you know what I mean. If you don't own them, even if you don't own them, still don't get tied down by those things. We have love conquers all as the another energy. This is yours, though, and it's the energy of the situation of this. Is this person a honey trap or a honeymoon situation? Well, with the devil card popping up, it's trap-ish. Full of drama, very emotional. You got to keep in, like, they have to keep in mind that, like, other people exist. And they have a really hard time doing this, too. They have a hard time giving into temptation. Okay. Your energy is love conquers all, enduring loyalty, eternal love, and lasting commitment. I feel like this is an energy of familial love, past love, whereas not somebody loving you, but you having love, living in love, and it conquers everything that you come up against, even the nastiest of the beasts. You have four tarot cards. The first one, we're pretty much elaborating on love conquers all. Number 21, right? Three. That's a number three. Nope, 24. That's a six. Okay. You have the High Priestess in reverse. Love conquers all. Not listening to your intuition, though. So, are you... I feel like... Okay, let me just pull more cards before I say anything. The Four of Wands. Okay. I mean, I'm sorry. Yeah, the Four of Wands. All right. I thought it was a little messed up. The Nine of Swords. Sorrow, sadness, and the Five of Wands in reverse. Huh. Okay. Okay. I'm going to push that and that and put this here. With the Love Conquers All, I feel like you've been really trying to like live in peace, harmony, and love within yourself. All right, right off the bat, poo people. You are having a hard time listening to your intuition. I don't know if it's at the influence of somebody else, but you are definitely having a hard time listening to your intuition. And you, yeah, it has to be somebody else, because the communication with someone else has increased and the intuition for yourself has decreased. I feel like you are hiding a side of you. Like behind that love and that strength and that compassion, everything that you tell people, you know, be strong, build up, you know, you can do it, you're worth it, all that stuff you build up for other people. I feel like you have a sorrow for that. Like you yourself have trouble believing some of these things. I believe someone is communicating that doubt to you. And you're not practicing what you're preaching. I feel like people have come to you about people like this person in your life. And you had all the tips and all the help. But this same person is doing those things in your life and you are not practicing. You're not doing those things. You're not putting your ideas in your words to the test for yourself. Instead, I see that you're very much just sitting in the darkness, kind of like living in it. I don't know if you're trying to learn more from it, but if it's done, it's done. Advance from that situation. You'll get the testing that you need. I'm going to pull out cards that I have not pulled out yet for these readings, and that is, they are my karmic cards, and they're going to give us a planet, a sign, and a house. They're going to give us what is happening. They're going to give us how it's going down and where it's going down. So let's just keep on going. Let's see what is going on. Ooh, the Moon. Okay, nurturing, introspection, self-awareness. Uranus, this is like a revolution. So right now in your innermost self, in your feelings, in the depths of your soul, in the depths of your mind, in the depths of your being, okay, your innermost feelings, that's what we're talking about here. That's the what is happening. Your innermost feelings, your innermost self, becoming one with the divine feminine and uniting your divine masculine and your divine feminine, for sure. All right. And what, how is this introspection, self-nurturing happening? Oh, there it goes. Ugh, it's always in Leo. This card, every freaking reading I'm doing, they all do it in Leo. That's how they're acting, Leo. And there's nothing wrong with Leo. I have a Leo. I love many Leos. But it's like, come on, we can't act like anybody else. Okay, so deep down, we have the Leo energy. So the moon is in Leo. Your introspection is one of confidence and impressiveness. What is the other word I'm looking for? Impressive. It's a synonym to impressive. I forget what I was gonna say. Remarkable, maybe? I don't remember. Okay, so with the moon in Leo in this one, in the first house, house of Aries, the house of self. Okay, that's not bad. I like this energy here. So what this is basically telling me is you're taking your innermost person and balancing it with your outermost person. Pretty much like I said, masculine and feminine balance. It's beautiful. I love it. The action that you need to take is to spiritually, you need to defend leadership immediately. So I feel like somebody's trying to come and take your spot, take your, like, and I mean, I don't mean like it's some rival relationship kind of thing. It could be, but that's not what I'm sensing. What I'm sensing is someone is just trying to control you in a way in which you don't like, I feel. It's making you feel some type of way. You need to lock that down now, because if they get too used to doing it, they're going to expect it. Mentally, you have to accept the creativeness of the way that you project yourself. Don't be afraid to be who you are and present yourself, express yourself as you are, because the right people who are going to stick around and are going to, you know, vibe with you and learn it from you and teach you things, they're the ones that are going to love every side of you, even the side, the creative side that you project, the way you project yourself. Okay, and physically, you need to let your feelings tell you how to do what you want to and do it on your own. So follow your gut, follow your intuition, just do it. You don't need nobody else's approval. You don't need nobody's help. You don't need nothing from nobody. You could use it. Everybody needs somebody, but you're so capable on your own. And once you realize that, you know, help, it's going to come, but you're not going to need it. All right, let's get the Akashic cards. I had already pulled them for you, there's four. I'm gonna put them right here. We have the Four of Scrolls, Karmic Trench. Ha, Karmic Trench. Five of Keys, Wishes Fulfilled. And we have another one, the Four, which is birth. So you have two fours and a five. 4, 5, 4. The five is in the reversed. Let's see what this card is. And 16, caught in the ruins. So you have two arcanas and two pips. Right. Yeah. There we go. All right. Let's see what these cards are saying to us. So where's my wand? Okay, here it is. The Four of Scrolls, this in the upright position, reveals a difficult pattern in your life. Okay. This pattern is of self-defeating feelings, thoughts, actions that you've brought forward from your previous incarnation. I think that's why this is coming up, that you this is the energy you're needing. Karmic Trench. A really deep like pathway of karmic debt and karmic like cycles. Okay. Wow. You returned to this life with the intention of breaking this karmic pattern, but you got pulled into your old thoughts and behaviors. You've been digging yourself deeper and deeper into a karmic trench that gets harder and harder to escape. This pattern is not known to you. It is recognized in your relationships, in your jobs, and certainly in your beliefs, behaviors, and responses. It's time to take charge of your karma by altering your inner ideas, feelings, and patterns that cause you to make sabotaging choices. Every time you notice yourself making an old choice that digs you deeper into that karmic trench, you can change your mind, you know, and your actions. This will require your conscious effort every step of the way, though. Without such work, you could go on lifetimes burying yourself in the same debt, in the same feelings. But without commitment to making changes every day, you know, you can't dig yourself out. Once you start committing yourself to changing every single day, like, okay, today, and I just said this, oh my God, it's so funny. I just said this a couple weeks ago. Okay. The next card you have is the Five of Keys. You have this in reverse. So you have wish fulfillment in reverse. And this card, it's a steam room. It's one of a successful estate because it's a pretty large size. And inside are keys and coins, wine, spices, you know, all those things that the upper class would have had. Also in the room is five baskets filled with fruit, vegetables, breads, flowers, sugars, grains. Even the many windows look out at the expansive world. When this card is in reverse, your dreams may feel as if they are somewhere off in the distance, but they don't have to be so elusive. Your dreams don't have to be so far away. They don't have to be so unreachable. I'll get into that in depth a little more if I can remember. You must work to change your circumstances as well as your responses to them. Sounds a lot like this card, don't it? Wow. Don't define yourself in lack. Stop downing yourself. Stop putting yourself down. And don't go on the defensive either, because that's your response because of your karmic past, your history, all that, the trenches you dug. Remain strong and steadfast in your little victories and your inner abundance. The most important key is getting your wishes fulfilled, and that is from a power within you. Keep working on your dreams, and your dreams will start working for you. I like that. So you're working hard to get out of it. You're like trying to harvest, trying to sow the field, trying to till, trying to plant, trying to overturn everything. You're trying, and really what you really should be doing, honestly, is working towards your goals, working towards your North Node, your destiny, your purpose in life, trying to figure that out and following it. Okay. So the next card, birth, which is number four, it's a woman in a field with a basket and two children. The sun is shining on her, and I believe this is England, and she stands in an ancient hedge in the distance and in the grove of the birch trees nearby. Birch trees, I have a rune, mother of the birch tree, so I feel like that's important, which represents the birch tree and stands for birth. A beautiful woman walks around carrying a basket while two children run happily towards her. With this card in the upright position, it's time for a new start. Perhaps an actual birth, or at least a metaphorical birth, a new job, a new hobby, a new career, new classes, whatever. An old phase is passing away and a new one begins. But even this new beginning has its roots in your deepest histories, in your past lives. Again, this is coming up. This card. There may be some labor sorry, there may be some labor involved, and it's a labor that bears fruits. It's a farm. Wow. And here, fruits, vegetables, keys, all types of stuff. So this is definitely like a harvest moment. Like, okay, there is some like growth situation, harvesting, spiritual and evolvement, something happening. Okay, this card is associated with fertility, sensuality, and motherhood. There may be a new energy of romance, possibly. Now I gotta pull my romance cards. The family or in home. You could be giving birth to a creative project. Whatever it is, celebrate. Prepare for the wonderful growth and opportunities that are about to come. Okay. So here is my dilemma at the moment. Do I pull the romance cards because the romance came up right here? Or do I pull the tarot cards that I have already out and then the romance cards? Or do I pull my astro deck to see where in your life this is taking place before I even pull out the... Yep, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to pull the astro, astro-numinous deck. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to pull that deck. Which actually, right on top of it, is laying the rune cards, which is Celtic, which is the mother of the birch tree, which is birth, which is the card we're talking about. So yeah, this is definitely the right deck to grab. Okay, I'm going to try not to shuffle too loud in your ear. Okay. All right. Let's see what energies. I want three or four. So the Four of Scrolls is clarified by Leo. Your karmic trench. This energy, this leadership, this powerfulness, this strength and creativeness, that's like, it's coming from all the karmic trenches that you're trying to dig yourself out of. Five of Keys, wishes fulfilled, please. Okay, almost went into my Zen deck. Mercury, wishes fulfilled. So... with the wishes fulfilled in reverse and then you getting communication, I feel as though closed mouths don't get fed. You have to speak up about what's going on and what you're feeling, what you're wanting, and what you're thinking to the universe, to your spouse, to your friends, to Gaia, to whoever you need to communicate it with. Do that. Have different perceptions. Listen to different perspectives. Listen to the universe. Listen to the earth. Listen to your friends. Listen to your mom. Listen to your enemy and hear their perspectives on things. Okay? Feeling like your dreams, your goals, your wishes are so far off, but you're just not communicating correctly. You have that warm energy. You have that old soul, that glow, that thing about you that's ripe and ready to share and love. All right, the birth. I was about to ask for the birth. Chiron. Wow. Okay. So with the like birthing something new, it's coming from a healing. It's a healing power, a growth. It's coming from this growth, this new creativity. Creativity is from a healing that you're going through. Self-doubt is even showing up here, like it has in these other cards. Divinity, cleansing, softness, pain, inherited issues, self-doubt, generational trauma, shame, forgiveness, amends, and release. So you're going through a healing situation, and I just feel like let it go however you need to. Crying is not weak, but no, you don't have to cry all the time either. You don't have to do it in front of people or to people or with people to be emotionally intelligent, okay? This healing situation, see it for what it is. I'm just going to clarify this caught in the runes, which we didn't even go over. This card, caught in the runes, it is in the upright position, and this is taking place in a medieval castle, and it's an old prison where the bars are still intact, and there's no roof, and there's vines growing all over the place, and a man and woman, they're still stuck inside on old tools, and there's beautiful green growth, forest growth, where the Castle is supposed to be. And this card shows a dark and difficult situation that seems to have you trapped. It could be a hurtful, empty relationship, an unhappy or stultifying job, something that's like stunting your growth or making you stagnant. A behavior or an actual addiction to drugs. Wow, did I say something about addiction? I'm pretty sure I was like, I don't know. Or even a negative sabotaging belief system that we just went through. Okay. I'm believing that's here and here, self-sabotaging. It has held you captive for some time, many lifetimes actually, and may have even begun in some past life. Wow. There is a way out, as there always has been. Just take some effort and determination on your part. Even if these limiting situations and actions are strong, they are self-imposed, and courage and strength require to change lie within. So what you need to change is within yourself. You cannot find it on the outside. You must change each faulty belief and every sabotaging choice that as they happen. Like, it's going to happen. You're going to make mistakes. You're going to go towards that direction, but change your course, change your mind, change your energy at that moment. If you do nothing, you'll perpetuate your attachment to the dark situation. Like the crumbling castle, negative choices can stand for a long time to come. Don't let the ruins of your past ruin your future. If you have power to climb out, climb now. And while we have these cards right here, what's the clarity of that? Okay, we have two. We have Dreams from Neptune right there. We have the Four, which is the roots and home. And we have Taurus, which is the bombshell. So this is like a very down-to-earth, productive energy. Something that is comfortable, very like homey, loyal, consistent, patient, homey for you. It's like very fulfilling, homey and fulfilling. Okay, so we have Leo twice, Taurus, Gemini, Virgo, Cancer, I think Pisces too, and this is Aries. High Priestess is Virgo, I think. Virgo's High Priestess, yeah, that's what I have so far. Okay, only a couple more cards, and your reading is up. So, this situation, you know what I have to say about this? You have a lot of growing to do. You are doing the right things. You have the right intentions, but they're not mature actions. Okay? They are not mature actions. I'm going to right there. The three cards that I had pulled for you. The first one's going to give me more information on this moon, which is holding on to the past. Holding on to the past, you, is not introspection. It's holding yourself prisoner, okay? So clarifying the Leo, the ordinariness in reverse. You can't be ordinary. Of course, you're a Leo. You have to always put your little pizzazz in it. Well, not you're a Leo, but like the energy of Leo's here. And the energy of Leo, always got a little, you know, like the salt guy. And for the first house, we have... the Tower card. And it was just saying, like, don't be ordinary for others. Like, basically, and then you have the ordinariness in reverse, and then you have the Tower card, like, okay, don't be ordinary. And then Leo comes up again, communication and healing. Okay. I'm going to take out of my Okay, this deck. So all I'm gonna do really is just start to get some clarity here, because I see that you have some, I want to say beef with someone, this individual. I don't want to say beef either. It's like there's tension there. I guess that would be beef, but there's tension there. I feel like this energy of the other person is just like very low self-esteem, like insecure, tries to manipulate situation, and you just try to lead with love. And let's see. All right, so love conquers, never mind. The Sun of Swords in reverse. So you cannot think of any other way to be towards a situation with this individual. So now, like with that, all right, let's see High Priestess and the Four of Wands. High Priestess, please. Okay. There's a lot of them on the floor, so I'm just going to pick them up and put them back in the deck and try to get an energy for the High Priestess. The World in reverse. Okay. So you're not listening to your intuition, because you really can't. You haven't ended a cycle. I feel like this person is supposed to be out of your life, and they're not at all. at all. There's a time of transformation at hand, and there's no transforming happening. Needing to, being able to, like, this person can indulge themselves in things and not get addicted while you're falling in love. They can expose you to something, and while they're fine, you know, the person or you or the person that they're dealing with is getting addicted to it. So it's like they are a dangerous energy. I don't know honey trap or honey honeymoon, but they're just I just feel like it's just a bad match. The Four of Wands, please. Lots and lots and lots of cards. Okay, Four of Wands. Okay, I'll take, if this is two, I'll take two. Yes, it is. Okay, so with the Four of Wands, it's like trying to keep things together, keep it, the Four of Wands even here, keep things together with participation and communication. But it's looking like you have to let that energy, this person, that's why they didn't come up the whole damn reading, because they're not supposed to be here. The Nine of Pentacles in reverse. Yeah, you are just not going to be happy with this situation. Where did that card go? Oh, right there it is. You're just not going to be happy with the situation. Like with this energy, the way that consistently, you're not going to like it. I'll just put it to you like that. Consistently, it's not for you. It's a once in a blue kind of energy. All right. The Sorrow card. What's the sorrow about? Is it letting the situation go? Is this situation making you like upset? You making them happy is just like self-sabotage. It's self-sacrificing. Let's see the Wands. All right. So for the Wands, we got the Moon in reverse and the Mother of Swords in reverse. So you are going through something where you're not even looking within yourself for the situation. Like you're hurting and you don't even look at it. You were going through something and you weren't even considering it. It's like you didn't, it was just all mental. It was like a chess game, a mind game. The Five of Wands. And maybe that's why you never did really go out there and put like your actions to the test, because you were like this mental chess master. You have the Emperor, which is Aries energy, and the Sun card, which is Leo energy again. So lots of fire energy here. So I'm feeling like that's why you didn't. You have this like boss type of mentality. Like, I don't even have to lift a finger. You don't even know what I'm doing to your mind type of thing. So I feel like this is, you both are pretty toxic in this situation. Like, this person's a honey trap and you're a trap honey. Yeah, there's no innocence there. Like, no innocence. You play innocent, but you're not. This other energy, it's like they met their match. That's why it's so neutral. I can't really get a read. Defend your leadership immediately. Doing things the way that you want to do that makes you happy. On the, what card was this? The clinging to the past, you have the Four of Wands, which is a participation, a action towards something, a unity, a combination, collaboration of energies. Okay. Collaboration of okay. So let's just see what, oh shoot, the Four of Swords. And I'm gonna ask for one more for this part, not even that. Okay. All right, let's try that again. All right, here we go. Oh, that's a lot. That's a lot. Okay. Ooh. You have the Ace of Wands in reverse. Okay. Oh, you got another one. The Seven of Wands in reverse. And that's not even supposed to be for this card. So let's just pull one more and we'll connect all of these like a string. Instead of it being for one, it'll be for all. It'll be for all. Okay. You have two here. You have the Sun of Cups in the Sun of Cups in reverse and the Magician in reverse. So you have all these blocked or negative energies. Everything is reversed except for participation. The Four and the Four are the two that are not reversed. Here with this Moon in Leo in the first house with all of these energies, I'm feeling like you're having a fight with your ego and your pride. Let me get my moon deck cards and see. Nope, matter of fact, I'm going to look with these. Okay. I'm feeling like you can't. You reminisce over the times that you were able to be as flamboyant and as expressive as you want it to be. You were able to express yourself completely. There was no newness about the only thing newness was like the different creative things that you came up with. There was no newness of people, like people's energies around you. They were not taken aback by the natural flow of you. They accepted it. They loved it. They embraced it. It was natural. But someone started just snatching their emotion away from the situation. As soon as they started seeing you express yourself, like be you and be happy. And it has nothing to do with you and everything to do with them. Okay. They don't want you using all of your pentacles. So you have the Age of Light. You've been training for this for lifetimes. You have Irama. Where are you being called to journey to? And you know what? I'm just going to put it like this because I think it would be better like this. And finally, Akasha. Wow, Akashic Records. We have the Akashic cards right there. Your guidance is divinely guided. Huh, nice. Okay, so to match those, I'm going to pull from the Starman deck and get clarity and get further information on those cards. So for the Age of Light, you've been training for this for lifetimes. I'm going to see what card comes with that. Okay. All right. All right. All right. Let's see. I hate shuffling on deck. On camera, but I didn't get a chance to before. All right. So Age of Light. There it is. Age of Light, Messenger, Sirius energy, bringing harmony and balance. You've been training for ages, for lifetimes, to be the messenger, bring harmony and balance. You have karma all over your reading. Very interesting, no? Okay. So continue to be the messenger the way you have. Look, communication and Mercury. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. Leo, courageous in your words. I understand. Okay, so Imrama, where are you being called to journey to? Whoa. Okay, so that's two. So I'm going to take both. Yeah, I'll take both. All right, we have double mission, Lightworker, Starseed. So the Lightworker and the Starseed cards. And it says, you've been training your whole life for this. That's very interesting. Double mission, Lightworker, Starseed, serve the world by being you. Did I just say that? I just said that. Okay, so serve the world by being you, but nope, there's more for that one. There's also Earth School, life lessons, soul growth, study, higher learning. So you have done this before. Like, you've been training for it forever. You've been to Earth School. Your soul has grown. There, that's why the Akasha that is there, your Akashic records, your higher self from, you know, the many, many times that you've learned lessons and evolved in a soul level. You're getting that energy. Look, Star Family, you're part of a team of souls calling for support. All right, so lastly, I'm going to clarify, Akasha, your guidance is divinely guided. Okay, I think this is two. Yep, but I'll take it. And here you have Earthed. Learning how to be a human in a world, but not of it. So yeah, definitely Starseed energy. I'm sorry, guys. All right, so the first card we have for Akasha is We the Hathors, Deep Love, Mother Milk, Birth as a Portal. So yeah, you definitely have done this. Your Akashic records, they're divinely guided, because your guidance is divinely guided because you've done this many times before. Like, you know the moms, you know the Hathors. Okay, and the other one is I am sorry, defenselessness, right past wrongs and uprooting karma. Yet again speaking, that's why you're here again and again and again, and this time as a messenger. Was that all of the cards that I wanted to use? No, this is the last deck. I wanted to use this. Hold on. Okay. Karmic Trenches with the Lover card, a flirtatious, creative, and expressive. Finally getting things done to clear your karmic debt, and communication as the messenger is definitely going to help. Your dreams are not too far off at all. If you just keep on going after them, don't block knowledge that is coming for you or knowledge that is coming to you. Take all the keys that you can, and then you'll always hit right on the spot. You'll hit every target that you aim for. Through healing, you are birthed anew with the birch. Wow. And wow, all the hard work, all the exhaustion, all the introspection, it's coming, it's paying off with the Nine of Wands. Okay, and with the fourth house sitting in ruins, and you have the roots, and you have the bombshell. It's an energy that you really should get out of, but I feel like it's really in your home. So what do we have for that? The Wheel of Fortune. There's no change, possibly negative change. Can I get some more information? There's too many. Can I get a little clarity on that? Okay. Here we go. Oh, and again, the Nine of Swords. So sorrow, like you have up there. So sitting in that same sorrow with all of these blessings, same sorrow. You know what you're going through now, same sorrow. That's why things aren't changing. You're stuck in that sorrow. Okay, yeah, I definitely need my moon deck cards because they are probably what you need. And then I'm going to read your Winnie the Pooh quote that I picked by rolling dice and see what it has to do with your reading at all. If the quote has anything to do with your reading. I honestly don't remember which quote I wrote. I really don't remember. Okay. So let's get some moon cards here. That almost had a jumper. I am going to put two up here. With the Love Conquers All, but your mind is being like definitely messed with, and you're not able to end any cycles, which is messing with your intuition because you don't know if you're listening to yourself or somebody else. You're kind of sitting in sorrow so somebody else can win. It's like, that's not how you win. And yes, you do have to be like lead in love and such, but that doesn't mean you have to let evil prevail. You have to defeat it with good, not be a martyr to it. I think if that makes sense. Okay, so you and your loved ones are safe. So yeah, go to take a stand and get out of that sorrow. Two more popped out, so I'm gonna take them. Be bold and make the first move. Absolutely, be bold and make the first move. Communication is key with the new moon in Gemini. So yeah, you don't have to sit around and like take a loss. You really don't. Let's see how this outcome is. Spiritually, there's going to be the nurturing of self-confidence to create. What is that? Okay. To create the nurturing of self-confidence to create who you are. Okay, so yeah, you are definitely like growing into this person, everything that you've been through. Mentally, feelings are caused by taking a chance on your desires. Okay, so you're starting to get a little like passion in there, you're starting to get a little happy, and I feel like that's where the ordinariness card comes from, and the Five of Cups, because you are at a place now, I feel like you want to share with a specific person, right? I am feeling that way. You desire this person. Physically, the reactions resulting from the impressiveness of your actions. So you're gonna have favorable results from everything that you do. Let's see what the moon cards have to say about this energy. The energy is gaining momentum and in the waxing moon. So you are just going to be learning from this whole thing. Like, you're going to see what people are trying to do to you when they're trying to bring harm or negativity into your life. All right, I just like two more for up here. Please, two more. Those two almost jumped out. Two more for clarity, please. Here's one, which is nothing will come of the situation. And one more. Okay. Capricorn? Yep. End of a tough cycle approaches. Yeah. So that situation with this person is going to be over. Like we've been said, it just keeps coming up over and over and over and over. I know I said this was the last deck, but how do you guys feel about like romance cards? All right, let me see. We have bring love into the situation. So yeah, I'm gonna go get the romance cards. Nothing. We have have faith in your dreams. All right, it's just saying the same things over and over to me, like that you have everything it takes, you have all the strength, all the wands, all the swords. Surrender to the divine. You're just not surrendering, you're being stubborn. How many are these? Okay, these are gonna be the last ones I take because a couple of them fell out. I think I'm gonna do the romance cards for you guys. I definitely do, since as soon as I asked that, bring a little love popped into the situation. Okay, so surrender to the divine. Okay. You have step out of your comfort zone with the North Node. So that's the right way to go. Like that's the destiny that you should be on. Believe in the impossible. And that's the blue moon. And a win-win outcome is in the forecast in Libra. So if you take these steps to just make yourself happy, let me get these love cards. You could truly, like, really, truly be happy, like, in self. Fully, 100% happy. Because, I mean, nobody's 100% happy, but you'd be content. You'd not content either. You'd be happy. You would literally be happy. You would be happy. There would be ups and downs, of course, but you would not worry. You would not have distrust or ill feeling. I'm so sorry about these cards. Let me, like, not even do that. That's whatever situation that you were in is coming to an end, and there's a new one coming. Like, Seriously, I feel it. Okay. Codependency. Addictions are affecting your romantic life. Okay. Oh, we have religious factors. Your love life is influenced by your religious upbringing and your spiritual path. Right? We have new love. A new person has stirred your romantic feelings. I said that. Okay. All right. Wait. Okay. So first this one. Attraction. You attract romantic love by enjoying this moment fully and past life relationships. You have known each other before. So the person coming into your life, you've known. Like you've known. Playfulness. Wow. To recapture romance, allow your inner youthful spirit to of fun to shine. And there's a strong magnetic attraction here. So you're going to come into this. Oh, wow. Express your love. Go ahead and make a romantic gesture. You're going to come to a situation with somebody where they are the one and you know it. And it's going to, they're going to come to you. You're not even going to go looking for it. You're not even going to be expecting it. Whew. Okay. You have this, like, I feel like you did all the hard parts before you even got here. You did all the hard work. And now you're here with me. After you did all the hard work. All the hard work you already did. All right, so what does Winnie the Pooh say? Listen to your intuition, possibly? I feel like you've passed that, though. Let's see. Hold on. Before I continue, let me make sure I'm completely satisfied. This person is a honey trap, not honeymoon energy. Because your honeymoon energy is here. Okay. You are becoming more confident, and that's good. Becoming more independent, and that's great. More creative, even better. You got to get out of that sorrow, though. Like, there's just times of, like, depression or sorrow that you get into. You have to get out of that. Yes, it's going to take time. Yes, it's still going to be sad sometimes, but not this these modes that you get into. Okay, so Winnie the Pooh, what does his quote say? I'm just a little black rain cloud hovering under the honey tree. Right, Winnie the Pooh. So a little black rain cloud hovering under the honey tree. Someone who is in sorrow and sadness that is just waiting for their taste of happiness, of honey, of sweetness. What a perfect saying, because that's exactly the energy of here. I hope that you enjoyed your reading. You have so much potential. You are not even of this world. And that is definitely clarified with this sitting over there in the corner. And then look what's underneath that is the first house. And under that is the Capricorn. See, it's just sign after sign after sign. This, everything is perfect. And this even had something to do with honey. Right? He has a honey jar, of course, and the reading is about honeys, honey trap or honeymoon. Okay. I like it. I like the grown and beautiful energy. Accept the love that comes into your life and make sure that on your religious factors, you're straight. You don't want none of that codependency. You just got out of that and you're not looking for that. I feel it. Okay. Have a blessed day, and I hope you enjoyed your reading. Hello. If you are here, you were drawn to the fourth pile by way of the energy, the stone, the tiger's eye, or the figurine Tigger. Tigger is probably my favorite character of Winnie the Pooh in the Hundred Acre Woods. Okay, tiger's eye. Let's talk about it. Tiger's eye is a stone that's known to bring insight to complex situations, protect from negative energy, mental focus. It is also you can see, I love this. It looks so beautiful. It almost looks fake or wooden. No, it looks kind of wood, but it's not. It's a stone. It attracts good fortune, grounds, and centers during meditation, grounding and centering for personal energies, dispelling any fears, and promotion of mental clarity. So this little bad boy does a lot. You know, it's not as sparkly as a crystal, it's a stone, but it does much. Okay. So what we're trying to do here is figure out if the situation that you're dealing with a honey trap or is it honeymoon? Okay. And I'm gonna start with the energy through dice. See what comes up. Okay, so two, which is fire, is the element in question or in focus. And four was the first one I saw. Four is, well, that die is the six-sided die, which is the die for problems. Okay. And the sixth problem is spectacle. Things seem worse than they actually are. Petty fights, aesthetic and surface level changes, playing with how things are perceived in order to achieve a desired outcome. So all I really hear and see with this is just manipulation, blowing things out of proportion, gaslighting, and being very flip-floppy. That's what I see. And the it's a one of the fire element, so it is one of doing, physically doing the action, physically being flip-floppy, and physically being combative over petty and small things. The eight-sided die is the next one we're going to next, and it is this is that's not it. This is it, and I saw the seven, and the seven is, if I'm not mistaken, the right mindfulness is what you need. Yeah, the right mindfulness. Don't make things out to be more than what they are. See them for what they are. No life is in change. And don't define yourself by the external or the environmental shifts around you and the state that they're in. You know, whether it's people or environment or surroundings or place, whatever, don't base yourself off of them. Okay. Okay. So, this person, this energy, or the energy between you and this person, is very immature. I feel like it's a tit for tat. I feel like you guys are always going back and forth doing stuff to each other, trying to see if you can hurt each other the worst possibly, or this could be the past energy of you guys, but that's what that was. All right? Just making a spectacle of yourselves. And, you know, one of you either has to or had the mindfulness to be more mature and not see things for worse than what they really are, to see things for what they are and what they aren't. Okay? The difficulty of the situation is that's a 60. So this person, this energy is, it's 60, what is the other? 7, 67. So their difficulty is 67 from 1 to 100. So they're really having a hard time with this, dealing with you guys' situation, how they're feeling, what to think. Like, I feel like this person right now is very honey trap. So far, I haven't had any honeymoons. I've only had honey traps. But we'll see. We'll see as the reading goes along. Okay, so 67 in difficulty. Oh, fuck. Okay. This was a 7 and a 67 in difficulty. And then you have the 6 for the when this occurred. And because there isn't a majority of even numbers, Yes, because there's a majority of even numbers. I want to say 6 p.m. is an important time, or something's gonna happen, or something did happen at 6 p.m. This could also be June. This could also be the summertime. This could be while you're waiting for harvest, like waiting for you to reap what you've put so much work into, or waiting for somebody to reap what they sow. Okay. All right. And it can also be a time of finding relief and relaxation. For the 6 p.m. situation, I'm feeling like it's a time of rest, dream, and to restore yourself. So it's like, I feel like this is after a situation. Like, I feel like you're no longer dealing with this person. I don't know if you're not dealing with them completely, but I know, like, on a romantic level, you guys are technically not in a relationship. At least it doesn't seem like it. Eight. And the eight is the strength card. The strength. Okay, so the lesson here is strength. Okay. And here it's to rely on your internal direction, sense of self, internal strength, and peace and resilience. And to not, like I have been saying through readings and not only this one, to not let the things of the past affect you. You have to be able to live past that and move past that and be strong past that and all of that stuff, you know? You can't be stuck in the past because of a situation. Also, I'm feeling Scorpio energy and Aries energy here. Anybody? Okay. Taurus, maybe? No? Okay. Gemini? Okay. All right. This person, I feel like, because they have the strength card, but they have everything else there with the difficulty at 67 and the element being fire and the problem being a spectacle, which goes right along with the fire sign, because they act out. We act out. That's what a fire sign does. And the right action is mindfulness. So it would take someone who, because if you act out in any other way, sometimes it just fuels their fire and they react more. But sometimes you have to act with mindfulness, because that will diffuse the situation. I've done it so many times. Okay, I'm going to be starting this one with tarot cards. So let's see what the cards got to say about your honey. Is it a honey trap or a honeymoon? So the first card that we have from the tarot that I pulled for you is the Two of Cups in reverse, the friendliness in reverse. So I'm feeling like it's a separation of friendship. Definitely. I feel like this person, like from them getting the eight as their lesson, that is why I feel like this person is not going to be good for you. That is a toxic, like, thing down there, especially having the 67 there. It's just all toxicity. You have the 10 of Pentacles in reverse, so not a feeling of completion, not a feeling of whole, not a feeling of having all of your resources, none of it. You have the Six of Cups in the upright, and you have, which is good, well, it's good because it's upright, it's a positive, but it's you looking back on something like it's a dream, like it's the best thing, like it's you miss it, it's a fantasy. And you have the transformation card, and that is the death card, and it's the cut off of something, to transform, to totally cut something off completely, kill it off, to grow and to change and to transform in such a way. I don't know if it's this energy or not, but I feel like it is the energy that I got with the, you know, the fire and the spectacle and all that. I feel like this is the person that broke your heart. Like, they ripped apart, literally ripped your world apart, like took it apart. The relationship that you thought could never go wrong, it just fell apart. That's what I'm seeing. And you miss it, and you look at it with such love and such like a picture perfect, this portrait perfect. But you're going through a change and transformation, and that had to be let go. It had to come off. Whether by choice or by force, it had to go. And it went. Let's see what we have here. We have an Oracle card and it is the Temperance card. Yeah, that happened to bring you to a balance, to bring you to a harmony, an understanding, like a place of full forgiveness and mental dexterity and emotional intelligence and resourcefulness and all of those good things. Like, that is the Temperance energy that this situation is bringing to you. It's transforming you into that energy. That's a good energy. I should know that Sagittarius is card and I'm a Sagittarius and that's Temperance. I know. All right, I'm gonna clarify with some cards. Let's just save like another Oracle card. Another Oracle. Okay, I'm gonna use these Zodiac cards and I wanna see what energies are at play here for the whole situation, because as of right now, I'm like, I don't know, but I'm calling Honey Trap. That's what I'm calling. He's everything you want on the outside, you know, says everything that you want, does everything that you know, you thought that you wanted, and I feel like it's all a game. Mars, the energy of action. Okay. Yeah, I'll put that there. Then we also have, what other energy? Nothing yet. Okay, here's one. The energy of Venus. So Mars and Venus. So the energy of action and war, I guess, but like aggressiveness and action and anger, and the planet of love. So I find that's the balance. Beautiful. This is Aries planet. This is Taurus planet. Yep, Taurus planet. Me? No, not Pisces. This is exactly the balance right there. War and love, anger and love and forgiveness. Okay. Cancer, emotional situation, very protective of self. Very protective of the ones you love, but most, but very, very protective of self. I was supposed to say shelf, like shellfish. That would have been pretty funny. Okay, I'm not taking, these are too many. All right. So here we go. Oh, too many again. If the same amount comes out again, because that's the second time three came out, I'm just going to take all three. I think I'm supposed to have all three if that happens again. And three is my number, so it could be me. It really could mean something. Okay, Pluto, transformation, Scorpio. Okay, so you have transformation right underneath each other. Oh yes, I love it. I love it. So there's definitely a transformation happening here due to the situation that you just went through, the emotional one, and now you're super protective. But you have come to a balance, like an understanding. Ugh, come to a balance. What did I just say? Wow. I love when that happens. Okay. Yes, yes, you are definitely at a balance. Like, you have a healthy degree of aggression and you have a healthy degree of love, and or at least you have a concept of it. You are a little protective of your you know, self, but of course you are. Why wouldn't you be? Let's pull. I think I'm gonna do these. Like, these are the ones I started going after, so I'm just gonna take them. So let's get some answers here. I don't know what kind of answers, but some answers from the angels with the angel answers cards. All right, so we're going to do those and these right here. Okay, so angel answers, let's see. What should we do here? What should we do? Ask your angels. Okay, angels, we're asking, what should we do? What should we do? Communicate clearly. What should we do in this current situation with the heartbreak? Ooh. Trust helpful people. Okay, cool. What else? Will the listener of this reading, I'm going to put this down. Ooh, look, opportunity. Will the listener of this reading, find what they're looking for soon? No, you're not. Okay, so we'll put those down. And let's see when, if not soon. It's two, I'll take them. Okay, and it is take action within the next few weeks. So that could be a couple months, the next few weeks, because 4 months, 8 months is 2 weeks, 16, not 16, 12 months is, yeah, no, 12 weeks is 3 months. That's what I was trying to say. 12 weeks is 3 months, 8 weeks is 2 months. So in the next couple of weeks, that's not very soon, but you should wait to take action. And that's what you're being encouraged to do. Okay, let's see what your Akashic cards have to say. Wow, the Willow in reverse. The 20 in reverse. Ooh, you're all reversed here. You're all reversed. The 6 in reverse, Divine Physician. So you have the Willow, 2 of Forces in reverse. Will, Wisdom, and the Mind in reverse. And the Divine Physician in reverse. But you have the 6 of Forces in the upright. Okay. So we have a reversed emotion, 2 major arcanas, and upright emotion. Wow, 2, 20, 6, 6. Okay, so here we have, like I said, the 2 of Forces in reverse, which is the Willow, the 20 major arcana in reverse, the 6 major arcana in reverse, and the 6 of Forces in upright. So the Willow. The Willow in reverse indicates that the winds of change or conflict are blowing around you. Don't try to fight it or you may be uprooted. You could be, it could be more it could be more than you can handle, okay? Instead, stay flexible, bend with the demand of the times. While it may appear that a period of total upheaval, like the Willow, you are to stay strong and capable, bending without breaking. Stay centered, yet adaptable within the circumstances swirling around you. You have a deep, strong roots in your spiritual identity, so rely on them now. This cycle of uncertainty will pass. In the meantime, let yourself be open to the guidance of the Akashic records. You are grounded in their wisdom and truth. Let yourself receive their power. Is that why this had to come to an end? Is that why you were transformed? You were ripped away from the situation because you had to go through this transformation. You had to go through this upheaval because that's what happened. Okay, so then you have the 20. The 20 in the reverse is Will, Wisdom, and the Mind in the reverse is at this time, your authority may be diminished and there might be a loss of position. You may feel like your talents, energies, and even your higher guides are missing in some way. Fire does not burn downward. Water does not flow upward. You've been spinning your wheels, overthinking things, and going around and around the same issues with little clarity about what's next. Though it still might be a time of great activity, much of that action can seem futile and repetitive. Nonetheless, the coat of arms of the Isle of Man Fly High, I guess this Man Fly High, the coat of arms, it's 3 legs, okay? Nonetheless, the coat of arms of the Isle of Man flies high, sharing its message that however you land, you will stand, even in the difficult times. So take a step back and don't try to fight the forces at hand. Get out of your head. Get out of your head and do what you can to reconnect with your higher guides. Your outer influence may be diminished right now because your crown has been toppled, but your strength and authority have now become the foundation upon which you build anew. You can bring mental, emotional, and physical balance back to your life by working with the exquisite and powerful energies depicted in this card. The Celtic knot, I believe that's what that is. A crown, a fire and water, and the man flies high. Fire and water. That's very interesting that comes up like that. Okay. Get out of your head. Okay. But your strength and authority have become the foundation on which you build anew. You can bring mental, emotional, and physical balance back to your life by working with the exquisite power and powerful energies depicted in this card, the more you become aware of the forces within you, the sooner the right flow of energy will return. More or less, what you put out is what you will get in. I mean, not more or less, but that is the end of that was basically what I was saying. Right now, you're just in a really bad position. Right now, you're possibly overthinking things. And you just need to know that you're going to land on your feet. This card here, the six major arcana, I believe this is Jesus, honestly. It's the divine physician, like, right? Anyway, the divine physician in the reverse is an energy that you may have lost sight of all that is required of your own self-care, or you might be on the path of discovering your healing gifts. You may have gotten sidetracked for a while. In any event, it's time to get back to your care. Get back to your own self-honoring and reconnect with your gifts. You may have also forgotten the power of your thoughts, ideas, and emotions, which are part of the elixir that brings healing to you and helps you bring healing to others. Make sure you attend to those ingredients as you put yourself back on your path. The divine physician, in words of power, and the action that take to support them will make you rise again. Basically, if you put your mind to it and carry out the actions, you can manifest whatever it is that you want. That's what that card is saying. You can do whatever it is that you put your, like, literally, if you think with your mind and you do it with your actions and you are sincere in your emotions, you'll come up with pentacles, with resources. Absolutely. Okay, last we have the six of forces, which is the waterfall. And in the upright, the element of water is fluid. It's like a waterfall. Your powerful personal energy never stops. Your life force is never ending. It springs from your eternal past and roars into limitless future, extending into the farthest reaches of the universe. It is a time of deep, thoughtful, and even deeper emotions. It is time for deep thoughts and even deeper emotions, as well as expansion of psychic energy. Use this time to act on those and tap your power that is flowing forever. Interesting. I expected there to be something particular. You can heal yourself, and while healing yourself, you can heal others. While tending to yourself, you can tend to others. You have that kind of energy, okay? What am I going here? This is what I'm gonna do. I'm going to put these cards down. So your next tarot cards, because I see like you are at a point of like literally transformation. It's a transition, you're changing. You have, wow, the King of Cups in reverse, on the Willow in reverse, two emotional things in reverse. You have, wow, the Ace of Cups in reverse. The Judgment card in the upright and the Emperor in the reverse. You are unable to reach full maturity with your emotions. Even with the, I feel like it's because the Willow is in reverse. You are unable to be flexible. You're unable to be fluid like water. Okay. Yeah, it's just an outpour. It's like you have like holes, like a strainer. You can't hold the wisdom. You can't hold any of that. Like you're losing your grip on these things. And I think it has a lot to do, and I see it has a lot to do with your emotions. The Judgment card in, well, the Ace of Cups in reverse is like no new emotional situations. No new emotional ties, nothing like that. No new emotional interests. With the Judgment card on the Divine Physician in reverse, the Judgment card is just knowing about karma. So, and he looks like he's healing too. So for this one, I'm feeling like everything happens for a reason. And if you're in a situation in which you're in, it's happening for a reason and you're learning something from it, or you're paying for karma from the past. Okay, just go with the flow of the Wheel of Fortune. Okay, you'll always land on your feet. And with the Six of Forces being clarified by the Emperor in reverse, it's like an energy of, it's like unstable. So all I see is unstable emotions. I want to get some clarity on some of these things here. Like, I need some clarity. What's going on? All right, so let's see. What's these outbursts of emotions? Okay, you're holding on to something you're not able to let go of, and you're supposed to be focusing on what's in front of you, and all you see in front of you is this thing you can't let go of. Ooh. Don't want to take those. Okay. Yeah, you are... you're just being somebody that people are not recognizing lately, I'm seeing, with the Six of Wands and then the Three of Wands. You're doing things, you're starting to just take action, and I feel like maybe the actions people don't understand. The Nine of Pentacles. Okay, so yeah, you're happy with these actions that you're partaking in, but everybody else is a little confused by them. Let me get the, what are you holding on to? What is that? Okay. So you are driven to become successful in some kind of resource, to gain a lot of some kind of resource. Hope. You have a lot of hope, a lot of willpower for it. What are these actions? Fudge. Okay, you're trying to listen to your intuition, and you have to make a choice. Okay, so I feel like, are you trying to divinate or talk to spirits or read cards or something? I feel like it makes you feel nice. You really haven't started. I feel like you're like at the beginning of beginning something, but you haven't, because you have to make a choice that you haven't made. Maybe you think you're listening to your intuition and you're not. You're listening to something else. Let's see. You have personal growth in the physical sense, like going out there and putting your actions to a good use, to sharpen your tools to grow. Okay. All right. And let's see one more. What can we get here? The Six of Swords in reverse. Six of Swords in reverse is not taking on anybody else's burdens. I feel like you're starting, maybe that is the situation here. You're letting go of emotional situations and focusing only on like physical resources, materialization. Look, it started from over here. If you see it the way I see it, it's a little ball and then it turned into a pentacle and now it's a full-blown star. And now you have to make a choice, listen to your intuition, and do what your intuition is telling you to do. And it's going to be hard. It's going to be a thing of personal growth, but you're going to feel so complete within listening to yourself that these actions, they're going to start happening even faster, and people are really going to have a reason to look at you like, what is going on here? Because you are no longer holding on to anybody's burdens. Okay, now let's look at the work your light cards. As we wrap up, we have the Great Gathering. It's all coming together into intuitive hits and soul tribe. All right, then we have Unbound, releasing your soul patterns, contracts, and past lives. Got it. And finally, Lumeria, creating heaven on earth. It's happening. And for those, I always clarify, or not always, but I'm, for this reading, I'm clarifying with the Starseed cards. Okay. Ooh, sorry guys. I'm so sorry. Let me just do this. All right. Can I clarify the Great Gathering? It's all coming together. Can I have a clarity card for that? Two, is it just two? Nope, it's three. All right, I only want two at most. I do not need three. I don't need three at all. Okay. All right, a couple of things tried to jump out. Wow. Star Keeper. Wow. Cosmic Ancestor, see the light by staying grounded. All right. I'll take one more. Ooh, and it just popped out as soon as I said that. Lifting the veil, questioning everything and anything that does not align must go. So yes, the Great Gathering, you know, you're coming amongst energies that are like yours. You're able to check yours a lot faster. I feel like you've been here many times before, so it's so familiar. I'm needing to clarify unbound, releasing soul patterns, contracts, and past lives. Oh, okay. You know what? I am going to take three for this one because of how it fell out. You have new earth, which is very interesting because creating heaven on earth, it's coming. A new earth, it's happening. Keep holding your vision. So I feel as though you believing in everything that you believe, people kind of think you're crazy maybe. You know what? I think I'm going to leave that here. Then you have wait. It's not time yet. Things are being woven. So I feel like your veil is being lifted, or it started to, or you tried to lift it or something, and it's just not your time yet. Look, baby steps. It's so funny. Action, follow your intuition before it makes sense. Intuition, this is exactly where it fell. And you had the action card and the make a choice an action card, and contentment, being happy, participating, like it fell right here. Baby steps. When something comes to your mind, even if it doesn't make sense, it's there for a reason. Listen to your intuition. All right. Creating a heaven on earth. It's happening. Let's get clarity for that. Ooh, okay. And exactly two. That's beautiful. Breath of the cosmos. My will to thy will. Micromanaging the universe. Okay. So heaven on earth is definitely like very expressed there, because you're micromanaging the universe. You're doing it here on earth. Then you have a double mission, lightworker, starseed, serve the world by being you. The last pile got that too. And then you have forge, don't follow. So we have a whole bunch of leaders, like in this, the whole situation, a bunch of leaders. That's all I see. Oh, what did I just do? I just dropped something, but I'm not sure what it was. Okay, now I'm going to use the Moonology deck. I'm feeling like love is not really your focus right now. Like, romantically, you might want a boyfriend sometimes or want to go on dates, but you wanted your last situation. Like, that was it. And now it's like you don't want anything else. You're changing, you're growing. It's not that you aren't ever going to date anybody else until you get this person back. It's just right now you just don't want to date. And that's fine. It's perfectly, perfectly fine. Natural, healthy. It's understandable. There's a card that is turned over here already. And that is adjustments are required. Third quarter moon. Right. Okay. So I want to get some clarity on these cards here. Let's see. Some adjustments are required. And I believe that's why. Remember I said something. This had to happen. This breakup had to happen. If not by choice, then by force. Like, this separation had to happen. Adjustments are required. Let's see what else is clarified up there. We have surrender to the divine. So don't try to go get that situation back. If it's for you, it'll come back. Don't chase it. What's for you will come to you. Okay, so we have the fire and water, which was very prominent down here on that will, wisdom, and things of that nature, right? Then you have the emotions. Okay, so I feel like your emotions are very much part of your transformation, but I feel like they're very much affecting them, and they need to get checked. Okay, let's see what the Moonology deck has to say about that. Well, the energy. Confidence is key to success. Okay, you have to be confident that this transformation is happening as a divine act. All right, yeah. Too much. You have to start to believe and understand that this is happening as a divine act, and not something that's happening to you, but for you and around you. Meditate and contemplate. There you go with the Pisces energy. Just get a little more in touch with your spiritual end, okay? And I feel like it'll work out. Look, the gentle two fish and the lion. Like, this is very religious, no? The fish is Jesus, the lion of Judah, the fish, Christianity, no? All right, let's see what else is here. I was gonna shuffle them, but I'll just do this. Okay, so for the great gatherer, star keep, and lifting the veil, let's get a Moonology card. And we have, again, Pisces, balance, spirituality, and practicality. Yes, you need to do some spiritual balancing and be practical as well before you can lift that veil. Trust me, eyes knows. Okay, for Unbound, New Earth, and Wait, what do we have from the Moonology deck? We have a new start is beginning. Okay, with the new moon, I definitely feel that with the Unbound and the Wait. It's like, don't jump in yet. There's orders to the steps. Okay, and for Lumeria, Breath of the Cosmos, and Double Mission, you have the end of a tough cycle approaches. Okay, I feel like this Earth cycle is the tough cycle that is coming to an end, and not in a death way, but more of like a heaven on Earth kind of way. Okay, I feel like your emotions are really, really like messing with you the most, because you are pouring out your cups and you are reversed in all your waters and you're holding on to something and you're going after it, this energy or this thing like hell, but it's just not working. So let's see what energies we get. We have, what do you need to release? Okay, so the Four of Pentacles, what do you need to release with the waning moon? Okay, I'm going to, well, it depends on how many these are. One, two, yeah, that's too many. I'll take a handful, but not that many. Okay, oh, there's another one. Oh, conclusions are within reach at the full moon eclipse. So you have to let something go, and right there, all your answers, right there, all your questions answered. This is the be bold and make the first move. Yeah. Make the first move and release whatever the Four of Pentacles is that you're holding on to. And we're about to find out, because I wasn't going to pull any more cards, but now I am, because I need to find out what this, what you have to release. How many cards? One. Time to give rather than take. Okay, so give up. Release this. Stop taking on so much energy. Expect powerful change. Oh my gosh. So I'm going to look real quick at this, thing here, this energy here of what you need to release, and I'm just curious. Okay, actually, this is what I'm gonna do. I'm going to see with just three cards what is going on here and what needs to be released and whatever and whatnot. So we're gonna start with the planets as to what's happening, signs as to how it's happening, and the houses as to where it's happening. All right, so planets. What's happening here? Oh, Mercury. You had Mercury communication. Yeah, Mercury. I think you had Mercury, if I'm not mistaken, or something along those lines that reminded me of Mercury. Okay, whatever the case may be, Mercury, and then you have the moon, introspection. Okay. You have signs, so there's some analyzing and communication going on here with the Mercury. Maybe there's things going on with your technology. Let's see how it's acting out, how it's playing out. It is playing out in Leo. Oh my goodness. Look at my last video. Look at my last video and see what I said about Leo. That's crazy. I don't even know what to do with that. I guess I got to keep it, but like that just, I don't, okay. I'm just going to leave it because it came out. There's Libra on the bottom, but like, that's weird that that keeps happening. And I said something in the last video that's wild. Okay. Let's see where this analyzing and communicating the King of the Jungle is happening. Where? In what part of your life? What house? In the fifth house. And the fifth house is one of like passions and love. The 11th house is here too. So what you should be doing, the actions you should be taking with your Mercury and Leo in the fifth house, is to communicate leadership with the trust of a child. So trust that nobody's going to screw you over or laugh at you or anything. Like, a child has complete trust. Communicate your leadership that way spiritually. Don't be ashamed of how you feel. Mentally, you need to analyze the creativeness of fun romance and making art. So analyze the creativeness of fun romance and making art. Look into fun a different way than you do, in a more creative way. Look into romance in a more creative way and making art in a more creative way. And art is music, writing, painting, drawing, whatever. Right. Right, right. All right. Then on a physical level, you have to let your mind tell you how to do what you want to and do it dramatically. Do it just like a Leo would. Even though I don't think that's Leo's house. It could be. I don't think it is, but I honestly could be completely wrong. Now the outcome. Spiritually, the outcome is the awareness of self-confidence to create the power of love. Lead in love. Do everything that you do, do it in love. And look, Leo, that's crazy. Mentally, the outcome, many thoughts about or from taking a chance on investment, gamble, and other games. So there's been an investment or like a gamble between money or energy or love or whatever, a time that it's been on your mind heavy mentally. It's been on your mind a lot. And that's the result of analyzing the creativeness of fun, romance, and making art. Okay. And physically, the outcome would be many words resulting from the impressiveness of your creations. So you having much to talk about because you have many accomplishments. Many accomplishments. So to let go, what must you let go of? What must you release though? The bragging, I feel like it's like a proudness that you have to let go of. I thought I would get my answer from there, but I gotta do this one then. What do you have to let go of? What do you have to release? What do you have to release? Okay, I would like to know what needs to be released from this situation in order for the transformation to occur completely. Okay, I hope it's not all that stuff that needs to be released, because like a lot of stuff just popped out. All right, and okay, there we go. What needs to be released? Immortal, a consuming family and pressuring peers. So what needs to be released is the toxic energies around you, period. Okay, here we go with Tigger's message. I feel like there's a big change coming in your life. You are where you need to be right now. Like, there's nothing else I can really say. Everything that needed to be said is said. The situation is over. The relationship is over. I know you loved it. You missed it and you needed it or whatever. Like, you felt like it was part of you. But this is all part of the divine plan. And who knows? You might see them again next lifetime. Okay? In the next couple of weeks, you may be able to act. And remember to get support from helpful people. Keep that balance that you have, baby. It's beautiful. Okay. Tigger's quote that I picked. Let's see how it goes with your reading. I am the only Tigger. Okay. This is quite a unique reading. You don't need anybody like pulling on your coattail. That person, this energy that was, is like non-existent. I don't know. I don't even know what to call it. I guess I would call it, a honeymoon because it puts you to this place, or I would call it a honey trap because it put you through so much that it got you to this place. So that is my reading for you, Pile 4, Tiger's Eye, Tigger choosers. release the negative energy from your life, friends, family, or otherwise. If it isn't serving you, let it go. Especially if you don't deserve to be treated in any other way but the way that you are asking, in a reasonable way, you know? I enjoyed it. A lot of Leo energy, remember that? A lot of Pisces energy, remember that? And a lot of water energy, a lot of water. So yeah, Pisces possibly. Okay, guys, enjoy the rest of your day, afternoon, evening, and be blessed. Like, subscribe, share, and all that good stuff.